हेलो एवरीवन, इन दिस वीडियो हम लोग प्रीवियस ईयर गेट क्वेश्चंस को सॉल्व करेंगे फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट डिजिटल लॉजिक डिज़ाइन, विच इज़ आल्सो नॉन एज डिजिटल इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स इन सम ऑफ द कॉलेजेस. नाउ आई विल ट्राई टू मेक दिस वीडियो इन बाइलिंगुअल लैंग्वेज. दैट मीन्स आई विल ट्राई टू रिपीट एवरी सेंटेंस इन इंग्लिश एज वेल एज एवरी सेंटेंस इन हिंदी, बिकॉज देर आर मेनी स्टूडेंट्स हियर हु आर नॉट वेरी कम्फर्टेबल विद जस्ट हिंदी लैंग्वेज एंड देर आर मेनी स्टूडेंट्स हियर हु आर नॉट कम्फर्टेबल विद इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज. सो that is why I have to take this session in a bilingual language. Now in this session we will be solving gate questions from 1987 to 2019. So if you are watching this video after 2020, so maybe I'll make a separate video for the latest questions of 2020. And in this video we will be solving the questions from Boolean algebra topic from digital logic. And the questions from Boolean algebra is comparatively very easy. Boolean algebra ke jo questions hai wo kafi asaan hote hain. As compared to this entire subject of digital logic, we have difficult portions also, but as this is the very first chapter of digital logic, so we have to start with Boolean algebra only. तो इस वीडियो के अंदर हम प्रीवियस ईयर गेट के क्वेश्चन को सॉल्व करेंगे 1987 से लेकर 2019 तक, और हमारा जो पहला टॉपिक रहेगा वो डिजिटल लॉजिक रहेगा. नाउ अगर आपको ये वीडियो यूजफुल लगे, इफ़ यू फाइंड दिस वीडियो यूजफुल, प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल, लाइक, हिट लाइक ऑन द वीडियो. And you can join our Telegram group. As you can see here, this Telegram group, whenever I make a new video, I post the latest notification of that new video in the Telegram group. Plus, I share a lot of study materials and content and practice papers in Telegram channel. So, aap latest information ke liye, please Telegram group ko join kare. And if you want to take our courses, please visit our website, which is www.digimento.com. So I hope that you will find this video useful. So let us start. So the very first question is from Boolean expression. So the question says as follows. We have A XOR B XOR A, and they are asking this equation is equivalent to which of the following. Now if you remember that XOR gate is not idempotent. Now what do I mean to say by this is, when you do A XOR A, so that is equivalent to 0. Right, so A XOR A is not equivalent to A, right? So this property is there in the XOR gate. Secondly, XOR gate is commutative. जो XOR gate है वो commutative है. So what is this commutative property? If I do A XOR B, this can be written as B XOR A. A XOR B को हम B XOR A भी लिख सकते हैं. So that means this given equation can be written as A XOR A XOR B. इस पूरी equation को हम A XOR B की तरह भी लिख सकते हैं, जहाँ पर आपके पास जो भी value आएगी यहाँ पर, if this A XOR A is basically equivalent to 0, so that will be 0 XOR B. And we know whenever we do 0 XOR B, so जो result आएगा, the result will be equivalent to B only. Because if I do 0 XOR some variable, so this will be that same variable itself. And if I do 1 XOR that variable, agar hum kisi variable ke sath 1 ko XOR karte hain, in that case it will be opposite of that variable. So in this case it will be equivalent to B complement, kyunki agar B ki value 1 hogi so the result will be 0, agar B ki value 0 hogi so the result will be 1. So this is something that you should clear. Therefore, this entire expression is actually equivalent to giving just B only. So the correct answer for this problem is option number C. It's a very easy question from the year 1987. Now let us look at the next question. Here they are asking, find the values of the Boolean variables A, B, C, which satisfies the following equation. So let us take these equations one by one. So we have the equation number 1. This is equation number 2, this is equation number 3, and this is equation number 4. Now, from equation number 1, we can say either A is equal to 1 or B is equal to 1 or both of them, right? Then only the value will be 1. But if you look at this equation number 4, from equation number 4, we know AB is equal to 0 only if either A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1, or A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 0. how I got this value is because of this first equation. Because first equation says दोनों में से कोई एक value जो है वो 1 है, and the second equation says, I mean equation number 4 says दोनों में से कोई एक value जो है वो 0 है. ठीक है. Now अगर आप इस केस में if you look at this equation which is a c is equal to b c which is your equation number 2. अब हमें क्लियरली पता है यहाँ पर दैट दिस सी एंड दिस सी शुड बी द सेम, राइट. जो दोनों सी है वो सेम होने चाहिए. एंड वी नो या तो ए वन है और बी ज़ीरो है, या फिर ए ज़ीरो है और बी वन है, मतलब दोनों की जो वैल्यूज़ है वो ऑपोजिट है. एंड दिस इज एंड गेट. तो एंड गेट में अगर हमारे पास सी ज़ीरो होगा, इफ़ सी इज़ ज़ीरो देन ओनली ये जो पूरी इक्वेशन है ये सेटिस्फाई करेगी, देन ओनली दिस इक्वेशन विल सेटिस्फाई. So from this we can say that C should be equal to 0. C की जो value है वो 0 होनी चाहिए. अगर C की value 0 है then from equation 3 I can find the value of A. तो equation 3 क्या है, A plus C is equal to 1. So put C is equal to 0. So this will be equal to A plus 0 is equal to 1. Therefore I can say the value of A is 1. A की value 1 है. So हमें क्या क्या values पता चल चुकी है, we know the value of C is 0 and we know the value of A is 1. Now just put this value here, we know here कि आपके पास a की वैल्यू जो है 1 है. हमें पता था कि a b is equal to 0 था. So and we know the value of a is 1, so the value of b should be 0. So the correct answer is the value of a is 1, the value of b is 0 and the value of c is 0. So in this way you can easily find the values of all these three variables. So basically it is just like mathematical equations. आपके पास चार equations given है, all you have to do is find what should be the value of a, b and c according to these four equations. This is very very easy question as you can identify from this. Now let us look at the next question here. The next question kya bolta hai, choose the correct alternative, more than one may be correct, write the corresponding letters only, the operator which is commutative but not associative. Isme se aisa kaun sa operator hai jo commutative bhi hai, commutative hai lekin associative nahi hai. Agar aap AND gate ki baat karenge, AND gate is commutative as well as AND gate is also associative. AND gate जो है वो commutative भी है और associative भी है. जो OR gate है, OR gate is commutative as well as it is also associative. OR gate जो है वो commutative भी है और associative भी है. अब देखो commutative का मतलब क्या होता है, what do you mean by commutative? If we have A or B, this can be written as B or A, right? Here it means A dot B is equal to B dot A. So this is the meaning of commutative. And what do you mean by associative? Associative का मतलब क्या है? This is a precedence. So if we a dot a plus b plus c, it should be equal to a plus b plus c, right? In the same way here it is a dot b dot c is equal to a dot b dot c. तो यहाँ से आप देख सकते हो clearly that AND gate is commutative as well as associative, OR gate is also commutative as well as associative. But if you look at this XOR gate is again commutative as well as associative. XOR gate जो है वो commutative भी है और associative भी है. But this NAND gate here, NAND gate is commutative but it is not associative. जो NAND gate है वो commutative है लेकिन वो associative नहीं है. So the correct answer for this problem is option number D, that NAND gate is commutative but not associative. Clear? Now let us look at the next question. Here they are saying let star be a boolean operation defined as follows. So star ki definition kya hai, when I say a star b that is equal to a b plus a complement b complement which is basically a xnor b. Agar hame pata hoga what is the equation of xnor, you know this is representing a xnor b. Ab unhone bola c is given as a star b, jo c ki value hai wo hai aapke paas a b plus a complement b complement. Now find the values of this equation. So the first equation is a star a, so a star a will be equal to a dot a plus a complement dot a complement, then this value will be a plus a complement which is equal to 1. So jo aapke paas a star a hai uski value aapke paas aayegi 1. It is very easy, right? But if you look at the second one says we have c star a aur hame c ki value pata hai, so c is a star b star a. And you can also write it this way, we have a xnor b xnor a. तो आप इसको इस तरीके से भी कर सकते हैं. Now if you know the properties of xnor gate then you can easily solve it, right? आप यहाँ से xnor की properties को apply कर सकते हैं. You know that xnor gate is commutative तो आप इसको कर सकते हैं. बट अगेन लेट मी सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन फॉर यू. ठीक है, ओके, लेट मी डू इट दिस वे. दिस विल बी शॉर्टकट मैनर. सो वी नो दैट व्हेन आई से ए एक्सनॉर ए, सो दैट विल बी इक्वल टू वन, राइट? इफ यू रिमेंबर दिस टेबल, दिस इज वेरिएबल ए, दिस इज बी, एंड दिस इज ए एक्सनॉर बी. द वैल्यूज कैन बी 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. सो एक्सनॉर एज्यूम्स अ वैल्यू 1 व्हेन बोथ ऑफ देम आर सेम, अदरवाइज इट इज 0. दैट इज वाई इफ आई डू ए एक्सनॉर ए, दैट इज इक्वल टू 1. एंड आई नो दैट एक्सनॉर गेट इज कॉम्बिनेटिव. आई नो ए एक्सनॉर बी इज ऑल्सो इक्वलेंट टू बी एक्सनॉर ए. सो हमें पता है दैट एक्सनॉर गेट जो है वो कॉम्बिनेटिव है. सो दिस इक्वेशन कैन ऑल्सो बी रिटन एज ए एक्सनॉर बी, एंड दिस वैल्यू विल बी इक्वल टू हाउ मच. तो ये जो वैल्यू क्या है यहाँ पर, सो दिस विल बी 1 एक्सनॉर बी. और हमें पता भी है, सो वेन एवर वी हैव 1 एक्सनॉर बी, सो दिस शुड बी इक्वलेंट टू बी ओनली. इसकी जो वैल्यू है वो बी के इक्वल है. सो इफ बी इज 1 देन द रिजल्ट विल बी 1, इफ बी इज 0 देन द रिजल्ट विल बी 0. सो फॉर द फर्स्ट ऑप्शन हियर द वैल्यू इज 1 एंड हियर द वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू बी. आई होप दिस इज वेरी सिंपल. द सेकेंड इज सॉल्व द फॉलोइंग बुलियन इक्वेशंस फॉर द वैल्यूज ऑफ ए बी एंड सी. सो इक्वेशंस आर एज फॉलोज. वी हैव ए बी प्लस ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट सी इज इक्वल टू 1, एंड सेकेंड इज ए सी प्लस बी इज इक्वल टू 0. ओके, नाउ फ्रॉम दीज इक्वेशंस यू कैन सी दैट हियर फ्रॉम दिस यू कैन से that this result will be 0 only if b is 0, b is equal to 0, as well as a dot c is also equal to 0. Then only this entire result will be equal to 0. So from this I can clearly say jo value hai b ki, b is 0. This is something that I know. Okay. Now if I just use this value, agar main is value ko use karunga in the very first equation here, so the very first equation is ab प्लस ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट सी इज इक्वल टू 1. और हमें पता है दैट दिस ए सी इज इक्वल टू 0. अगर ए सी जो है वो 0 है, ठीक है, आई मीन वी नो बी इज इक्वल टू 0, सो दिस इज 0. सो आई कैन राइट इट एज 0 प्लस ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट सी इज इक्वल टू 1. देयरफॉर आई कैन से ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट सी इज इक्वल टू 1. सो आई नो टू वैल्यूज. आई नो दैट ए सी इज इक्वल टू 0 एंड आई नो ए कॉम्प्लीमेंट सी इज इक्वल टू 1. It means that the value of C should be 1 and the value of A should be 0. So here this complement will also becomes 1. So now I hope I know the values of all the variables. I know that value of A is 0. I know the value of B is 0. And I know the value of C is 1. So the correct answer is 0, 0, 1. So in this way, you can solve this question very easily. It's a very, very easy question as you can see here. Now let us look at this problem here. This problem says, what values of A, B, C and D satisfies the following simultaneous Boolean equations? So, हमें कुछ values given है. So, we know that A complement plus AB is equal to 0. We know that AB is equivalent to AC. We know AB plus AC complement plus CD is equal to C complement D. These equations are given. Okay. Let us take these equations one by one. This is equation number 1, this is equation number 2, and this is equation number 3. So let us take equation number 1. Equation number 1 says that A complement plus AB is equal to 0. Now on the equation number 1, I can apply the distributive property. So iske upar main distributive property apply kar sakta hu. To yahan par aayega A complement plus B dot A complement plus A, which is equal to 0. So this can be written as A complement plus B is equal to 0. So this will be 0 only if B is 0 as well as this entire A complement is 0. So we can say that the value of B is 0 and the value of A is 1. So we know two values now. Okay. Now if we know these two values, I can easily find out the value of equation number 2. So from equation number 2, I know that AB is equal to AC. I know the value of B is 0, I know the value of A is 1, I know this value of A is also 1. So I can say it 0 is equal to C, right? Therefore the value of C variable is also known. So value of variable A is 1, the value of variable B is 0, and the value of variable C is 0. These things we know right now. Okay. Now we can also find the value of variable d from these things. From equation 4 I can find the value of d, but again let us see if we can eliminate any of these options. So this option number A is fine, I cannot eliminate option number A, right? And I can eliminate option number B, and I cannot eliminate option number D, and I can eliminate option number C. So far we have eliminated option number B and C. Now let us look at equation number 4. So equation number 4 says that AB plus AC complement plus CD is equal to C complement D. So just put all these values. The value of A is 1, the value of B is 0, the value of A is 1, the value of C is 0, so C complement will become 1. So C ki value jo hai wo 0 hai, to C complement ho jayega 1. So this is 0 and this D is as it is, and then this C complement is 1 dot D. So that means I can say this result will be 0 plus 1 plus 0 is equal to D. Therefore I can say D is equal to 1. So the value of the variable D is equal to 1. Hence the correct answer is option number A, and option number D is wrong in this case. I hope that you understood this question. This is a very easy question. There's nothing very difficult in any one of these questions. Okay. Let us look at the next question. Here they are saying, let star be defined as X star Y is equal to X complement plus Y. Now we have a variable Z. So Z is X star Y. Z ki value hume pata, it is X star Y. So what is the value of Z star of X? Okay. So when you do Z star X, so just put the value of, just put the value of Z here. So Z ki value kya hai? This is X star Y star X. So this is the value of Z. Now from this, you can just put their values. So it X star Y means it is X complement plus Y star X. Again, let us assume that this is X and let us assume that this is Y. So you can apply the same formula. So this value will become your X complement plus Y whole complement plus X. So now you can easily solve it. You can apply De Morgan's law on this. So this is X complement complement dot Y complement plus X, which is equal to X dot Y complement plus X. So that means you can take X as common. So this is Y complement plus 1, which is actually equivalent to saying X only. So the entire result of this equation is equivalent to X. Therefore, option number B is the correct answer for this problem. This question was asked in year 1997. Now let us look at the next question. Again, this is a very, very interesting question. Very tricky, not very tricky, but if you know the property, it's very easy question. They are saying, what happens when a bit string is XORed with itself n times? So here we are having XOR gate. So if you know XOR gate, if you do A XOR A, agar aap A ko khud ke saath XOR perform karte hain, so this A XOR A is equivalent to saying, so when let me just make the table here also. This is A and this is B, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. And this is A XOR B. So if both these values are different, then only this value will be 1. Otherwise, this will be 0. So when I do A XOR A, that means both these values are same. So the result will be 0. Correct? But if I do A XOR A XOR A, then the result will be 1. So the property says something like this, that if it is repeating even number of times, if this is repeating even number of times, that is, even if we have A XOR A XOR A XOR A, if this is repeating even number of times, then the result will be 0, and this can repeat any number of times. And if it is repeating odd number of times, like A XOR A XOR A XOR A XOR A, so here 5 A are there, so the result will be 1. So here it is odd number of times, odd number of times, right? So in this case, if the value of n is even, if the value of n is even, then the result will be 0. But if the value of n is odd, then the result will be 1. This is a very straightforward direct property of XOR gate. Now in options, it says option number D. So remains unchanged when n is even. So whenever the value of n is even, every time you are going to get a answer as 0. Otherwise, when the value of n is odd, then you'll always get an answer as 1. So correct answer for this problem is option number D. Now let us look at this question again. This is a very easy question. This question we have already done before also. So they are asking which of the following operator is commutative but not associative, and we have seen this question before also. Is question ko humne pehle bhi check kiya tha. So I know the correct answer is option number C. This NAND gates are commutative but they are not associative. Then which of the following expressions is equivalent to x complement? Isme se kaun si expression jo hai wo x complement ke equivalent hai. If you remember it, I told you in the classroom itself, you can convert a NAND gate to a NOT gate as well as you can convert a NOR gate to a NOT gate. So in case of a NAND gate, agar aapke paas ek NAND gate hai, right? So in a NAND gate, this is your NAND gate. If this both these inputs are X, so the result will be X complement. In the same way, in NOR gate also, if both the inputs are same, both the inputs are X, the result will be X complement, right? So in this case, this statement is true because they are equivalent, right? This is equivalent to X complement, right? In the same way, this is also true because this is equivalent to X complement. If you look at this value here, X NAND 1. So just check out the table of NAND gate. This is X and this is Y and this is X NAND Y, right? So combinations can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So this X NAND Y will be 0, 1, 1, 1. Now if you look at carefully, whenever we have 1 here, so if the value of X is 1, so the result will be 0. If the value of X is 0, then result will be 1. So this is also equivalent to X complement. But if you look at this value for the NOR gate, so just check this table for NOR gate, X NOR Y, so 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1. So for NOR gate, the values are 1, 0, 0, 0. Now in this case, if you look at it carefully, whenever the value of this Y is 1, jab bhi Y ki value 1 hai, so this is equivalent to X. Matlab jo bhi X ki value hai, same value will be X NOR Y. Here also, this is also equivalent to, this is equivalent to 0. Actually not even X, this is equivalent to 0. So in if Y is equal to 1, then X NOR Y will be equal to 0. Us case mein iski value hamesha 0 hogi. So this result will be equivalent to 0. This result is not equivalent to X complement. So correct answer is option number D, because they're asking which of the following is not equivalent to X complement. Isme se X complement ke equivalent kaun sa nahi hai. To iska jo answer hoga wo hoga option number D. Very straightforward answer, very easy question. Now again, the simultaneous equations of the boolean variables X, Y and Z, W are given below. Have the following solutions of X, Y, Z and W respectively. So what you can do in this question is, you can either solve these equations, aap in sabhi equations ko solve kar sakte hain, and then you can come up for the values, or the second way is that you can insert these values. In the previous questions, pichle questions mein I already told you ki aap in equations ko kaise solve karenge, how can you solve these equations, but in this video let me just insert these values and let us see ki kaun kaun si values in sabko satisfy karti hai, theek hai? Let us take the first value. So here the value of X is 0, Y is 1 and Z is 0. Here the value of X is 0, Y is 1. Here the value of X is 0, Z is 1, Z is also 0, because the value of X is 0, Y is 1, Z is 0 and W is 0. And here W is also 0. And here the value of X is 0, Y is 1, Z complement will be 1 and this W will be W complement will be 1. So now check karo. This result is 1, this is satisfied, this result is satisfied, this result is not satisfied. So first option say jo ye jo result hai ye satisfy nahi hoga. You can just insert these values of X, Y and Z and you will feel that the result should be 0. So first option jo hai wo satisfy nahi kar raha hai. Clear so far? Now let us look at the next option. So option number B is saying that X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 1, Z is equal to 0 and W is equal to 1. So that means I'm going to put these values here. So X ki value aapke paas 1 hai, Y bhi 1 hai, Z 0 hai. X ki value 1 hai, Y bhi 1 hai. So yahan par aap check kar sakte ho, here this condition is not satisfying because 1.1 is equal to 1. So yahan par jo result hai wo match nahi kar raha. So option number B is also not matching. Right? So now let us look at option number C. So option number C says X is equal to 1, Y is equal to 0, Z is equal to 1 and W is equal to 1. Insert these values. So we have 1, 0, 1. This is 1 and 0. This is 1, 1 and W is going to be 1. And this 1, 0, and z complement here, z complement ki jo value hai that will become 0, and w complement ki jo value hai that will also become 0. So this first condition is satisfying, the second statement is also satisfying, third is also satisfying, fourth is also satisfying. So for this problem the correct answer is option number C. So option number C jo hai wo sabhi equations ko satisfy kar raha hai. Next, if the value of f of a comma b is equal to a complement plus b, then we have to find the value of f of x plus y, comma z. हमें इसकी वैल्यू को फाइंड आउट करना है. सो लेट अस डू वन थिंग, वी विल स्टार्ट विद द इनर मोस्ट इक्वेशन, हम इसके साथ स्टार्ट करते हैं. सो लेट अस फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ x plus y, comma y. सो इंस्टेड ऑफ a जस्ट पुट x plus y, इंस्टेड ऑफ b जस्ट पुट y, देन यू विल गेट x plus y होल कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस y, दिस विल बी इक्वल टू x कॉम्प्लीमेंट डॉट y कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस y, एंड इफ यू अप्लाई डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव लॉ सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू x कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस y आफ्टर अप्लाइंग द डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव लॉ. ठीक है, आप इस पर डिस्ट्रीब्यूटिव लॉ अप्लाई करेंगे, यू विल फाइंड द वैल्यूज x कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस y. नाउ इंसर्ट दीज वैल्यूज हियर, सो वी हैव f ऑफ x कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस y, कॉमा z. सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू x कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस y होल कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस z, विच इज इक्वल टू x कॉम्प्लीमेंट कॉम्प्लीमेंट डॉट y कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस z, विच इज इक्वल टू x डॉट y कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस z. सो एज यू कैन सी दिस इज वेरी वेरी इजी, काफ़ी इजी क्वेश्चन था, इसमें कोई भी प्रॉब्लम नहीं थी. इट्स वन ऑफ द इजिएस्ट क्वेश्चन दैट यू कैन एवर कम अक्रॉस इन द एग्जामिनेशन, एंड द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर सी इन दिस केस. इस केस में जो करेक्ट आंसर है वो ऑप्शन नंबर सी है. नाउ लेट अस लुक एट दिस बुलियन फंक्शन, दे आर गिविंग अ बुलियन फंक्शन एंड देर आस्किंग विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज इक्वलेंट टू दिस. सो वी हैव एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस एक्स वाई प्लस एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई. सो यू कैन क्लियरली सी फ्रॉम दीज टू आई कैन टेक वाई as common, so this is x complement y complement. So if I take y as common, I will get x plus x complement, which is equal to 1. So this can be written as x complement y complement plus y. Again you can apply distributive law, ab yahan par distributive law apply kar sakte hain. So this is x complement plus y dot y complement plus y, which is equal to x complement plus y only. So this entire equation is equivalent to x complement plus y, which is option number D. So option number D is a correct answer for this given problem. I hope that you understood this part. Next, the functions a b complement c plus a complement b c plus a b c complement plus a complement b complement c plus a b complement c complement is equivalent to which of the following. So we have a b complement c plus a complement b c plus a b c complement plus a complement b complement c plus a b complement c complement. Now there are many ways of solving this problem. You can apply K-map on this, right? But again, because we are not using a K-map, so directly we are trying to come up to the equations. ठीक है, हम लोग यहाँ पर K-map नहीं use कर रहे हैं, but I can easily solve this question using a K-map, and then this question will become very very easy, as you can see. Okay, so let me solve this question both the ways. I believe some of you might want me to solve using a K-map. तो सबसे पहले हम इसको K-map के through solve करते हैं, and we have three variables here. So we have a variable a, we have a variable b, and we have a variable c. So this value will be a b complement c complement, b complement c, b c, and b c complement, and this is a complement and a. So the values here, when I say a b complement c, this is 1, and when I say a complement b c, this is 1, and a b c complement, this is also 1, and a complement b complement c, this is 1, and we have a b complement c complement, this is also equivalent to 1, right? Now here you can find make subcubes here. So what are the subcubes that are possible? You can make this subcube, aap yahan par isko subcube bana sakte hain, and you can make this subcube, correct? And you can also make this subcube. Aap is tarike se you can make some subcubes, right? Iske alawa bhi there are other subcubes are also possible. Let me also show you one more way of making a subcube. So what you can do is you can make them as a subcube. आप इन दोनों को एक subcube बनाएंगे, and then you can make this as a subcube. So you can clearly see for this K-map, you have multiple solutions are available. इस K-map के लिए multiple solutions available है, right? Because one implicant is there जहाँ पर essential prime जो है वो नहीं है, okay? But anyways, let me show you the solution here. So this subcube is representing BC. And this subcube is representing A complement and C. And this subcube here, it is representing A and C complement. So that means using this, the answer should be A complement C plus AC complement plus B complement C. Okay. Now let us see if this answer is matching. If it is not matching with any of the options, then I have to check for other options. Okay. So in the first case, A C complement, this is there, A B is not there. So this option is not matching for this equation. Let us look at the second option here. So in option number B, we have A B complement plus A C complement plus A complement C. Again, this is also not matching. In the third option, again, you can see it is also not matching, because in each of these options, we are getting A B. In सभी options में हमारे पास A B आ रहा है. That means I have to make another subcube. इसके अलावा जो दूसरा subcube हमने check किया था, I have to use that another subcube. Let me show you how can I use it. This is your A and this is your BC, right? Now in this case, again, you can make this table B complement, C complement, B complement, C, BC and BC complement. And this is A complement and A. Now the values 1 are 1, 1, 1, 1 and 1. So that means I can make the following subcube, that I can use these here. So I can make a subcube with this, right? And I can make this subcube and I can make this subcube. Instead of that one, I can make this subcube. मैं ये वाला subcube भी यहाँ पर बना सकता हूँ, ठीक है? So if I am making these subcube, so ये जो subcube है, this subcube is representing A C complement. This subcube here, it is representing what? It is representing A B complement, right? And this subcube here, it is representing A complement C. So that means the equation will be A B complement plus A C complement plus A complement C. Now check if it is matching with any of the answers, right? So here we have A B, so obviously it is not matching. Here we have A B complement and we have A C complement and we have A complement C. So option number B is correctly matching with it. Option number B jo hai wo directly yahan se match kar raha hai. In the same way, you can see option number C is not matching and option number D here, it is also not matching. So correct answer for this problem is option number B. So this is the very first way of solving this problem using the K-map. Aap is tarike se K-map ko use karke is problem ko solve kar sakte hain. But what can be a second way? Second manner could be if you are using the Boolean algebra axioms. So how I can use A B complement C plus A complement B C plus A B C complement plus A complement B complement C plus A B complement C complement. Now you can clearly see that we need A B complement. So I can take A B complement as common from this equation, and from this equation I can take A B complement as common. So we'll get C plus C complement plus, now I can take another equations. Now I can take this equation and this equation, and I can take A complement C as common. So inside there will be B plus B complement, and then we have A B C complement. So this will be equal to A B complement plus A complement C plus A B C complement, right? Now from these two equations, I can take I can apply distributive law. मैं यहाँ पर distributive law को भी apply कर सकता हूँ, right? और instead of this, I can use these two equations also. मैं दोनों equations को use कर सकता हूँ. So if I take these two equations, so this will be equal to, I can take A as common. So this is B complement plus B C complement plus A complement C. Now from this equation, again you can apply distributive law. तो अब इस पर distributive law apply करेंगे. So this is equal to B complement plus C complement plus A complement C, and this will be equivalent to A B complement plus A C complement plus A complement C. In this way also you can solve this problem. So again you will get the answer is option number B. आपको यहाँ पर option number B answer मिलेगा. So as you can see, there are two ways of solving this problem and I have shown you both the ways. Okay. Now next problem is, which of the following expression is equivalent to this given expression? तो आपके पास जो expression given है, that is A XOR B XOR C. A XOR B XOR C, right? Now you can try and solve this problem. There are many ways of solving this problem. ठीक है? तो I think I've written it wrong. So let me write it again. So it is A XOR B XOR C. Fine. Now let us open these brackets. So if I open these brackets, so this will become A B complement plus A complement B XOR C, which is equivalent to which of the following? It is again, this is AB complement plus A complement B XOR C, and again if you open this XOR, so this will become AB complement plus A complement B dot C complement plus AB complement plus A complement B whole complement dot C. Now this dot here, this will make it as a XNOR gate. This will make it as XNOR gate. So ye jo hai aapko ek XNOR gate banayega, right? So but again you can see it here, this can be equal to A B complement C complement plus A complement B C complement plus this is A B plus A complement C complement dot C. Again if you open it, this is A B complement C complement plus A complement B C complement plus A B C plus A complement C complement and this is B, right? So this is B and B complement. So A complement, this is A complement, B complement and C. Okay, so this is the equation that you are going to get. Now what you have to do is either you can solve this equation and you can come up to the any one of these options. Aap is puri equation ko solve karke upar mein se kisi option ke sath aa sakte hain. Or you can do is you can open the above options. So matlab aap sabko open karke and then you can check ki aap isme se kaun sa solutions aapke sath match ho raha hai. Theek hai, now you can clearly see yahan par you have total of four min terms, and in all of these four min terms all these three variables are coming, right? So this is a sum of product expression, this is an SOP expression, and the first option is given as POS expression and the second option is also given as product of sum expressions. So logically both of these two POS expressions should not be the same, but again you can try and open this POS expression and you can compare this POS expression with this. So aapka jo comparison hai, maybe that answer will not match. Let me show you for the option number A. Anyways, I will basically skip option number A and B. I will just check option number C in the examination, but again let me show you with option number A first. तो examination मैं खुद अगर personally attempt करता तो मैं directly option number C को check करता, मैं option number A और B को यहाँ पर check नहीं करता, because वो दोनों जो expressions है वो product of sum expression है और जो मुझे expression मिली है ये sum of product expression है. बट मैं फिर से option number A आपको check करके बता देता हूँ. So this will be equal to A dot A complement plus A dot B complement plus A dot C complement plus B dot A complement plus B dot B complement plus B dot C complement plus C dot A complement plus C dot B complement plus C dot C complement. So here this value will be 0 and this value will be 0 and this value will be 0. So we will get A B complement plus A C complement plus A complement B plus B complement C complement plus A complement C plus B complement C. And from this you can see even if you try and open it, you will find out that this is not even matching this with this given equation, right? So that is why I will not check option number A. So let us directly check option number C. So option number C is giving ABC plus A complement B XOR C plus B complement A XOR C. So let us open this. So it is ABC plus A complement B complement C plus BC complement plus B complement into A complement C plus AC complement, which is equal to ABC plus A complement B complement C plus A complement B C complement plus B complement A complement C plus B complement A C complement. Now here in this equation, is there any terms that can be combined? So you can see this term as well as so this is A complement B C complement, right? Then you can see this term and this term can be combined. Ye dono jo terms hai combine ki ja sakti hai. So I'll get A B C plus A complement B complement C plus A complement B C complement plus A B complement C complement. And you can see this is actually matching with this. To aapke paas ye jo term hai, the first term here which is A B complement C complement is given here. The second term A complement B C complement is given here. The third term is given here. And the fourth term is actually given here. So you can see the correct answer is option number C, because option number C is directly matching with this equation. So option number C jo hai wo yahan se match kar raha hai. So this should be a correct answer for this given problem. Theek hai? Okay, so let us look at this question. And this question is from GATE 2007. So we have four equations here and they are giving us value here for the function, they are asking which of these equations is equivalent and which of the following is not equivalent. So let us solve the first one. So we have the equation P, which says we have x complement y complement z complement plus w complement x y complement plus w y complement z plus x and z. So you can see in each of these terms only one term is missing. Okay, so let me use something, a variable for that one term. I can, let us suppose I am using a variable m for that, right? So for missing term I'm using a variable m for this, right? So that means here what is missing, here w is missing, so I can write m instead of that, and I'm going to write the values of these terms. So this is 0 0 0 plus, here you can see here w is there, x is there, y is there, but z is missing. So I can write 0 1 0 and m plus, here we have w is there, so w jo hai wo yahan par already available hai, right? So which is 1, y is, x is not here, so I'm going to write m here, so 0, and z ki jagah par I'm going to write 1. Ab yahan par you can clearly see yahan par w is missing and y is missing, so I can write m 1, y ki jagah par I'm going to write m, and for z I'm going to write 1, z ki jagah par bhi I'm going to write 1. So this value is going to be, again wherever I have to write, I have written m, to har ek term ko I have to write, instead of m I have to write a value 0, as well as I have to give a value 1. So yani ki jo first term hai, the first term can be written as 0 0 0 0 plus, it can also be written as 1 0 0 0, yani ki jahan par m hai uske jagah par ek bar aap 0 rakhenge aur ek bar 1 rakhenge. Then the second term here, it is 0 1 0 0, and it can also be written as 0 1 0 1. Jo third term hai, this can be written as 1 0 0 1, and it can also be written as 1 1 0 1. And the fourth term hai, it can be written as 0 1 0 1 and 0 1 1 1 and 1 1 0 1 and 1 1 1 1. So this value is 0, this is 8, this is 4, this is 5, this is 9, this is 13, this value is 5, and this value is 7, this value is again 13, and this value is 15. So this P can be represented as, P can be represented as summation 0, 5, 4, 5, 7, 9, 13 and 15. So yahan par 0, 4, 5, 7, 9, 13 and 15 aayega, and plus 8 is also there, plus 8 is also there. So you can see P jo hai, P is directly matching with this. So option number P is correct. Correct. So agar hamara P true hai, to directly you can see that option number A jo hai, aap usko directly eliminate kar sakte hai, because they are asking which of following is not equivalent. So from this you can directly eliminate option number A. Ab option number A ko yahan se directly eliminate kar sakte hai. So let us look at option number B, I mean the statement number Q. So Q is saying is W complement Y complement Z complement plus W X complement Y complement plus X Z. Again I'm going to write a term, let us suppose M here. So this will become 0 M 0 0 plus, this will become 1 0 0 M plus, this will become M 1 M 0. So ye jo term banegi, this is 0 0 0 0 plus 0 1 0 0 plus ye jo term banegi, this is 1 0 0 0 plus 1 0 0 1 plus ye jo term banegi, this is 0 1 0 1 plus 0 1 1 0 plus 1 1 0 0 plus 1 1 1 0. Okay, so sorry, here it is 1, right? So last term is 1, last term is not 0, this is 1. So I've done this silly mistake here. So here we have 1 1 1 and 1, right? So this term is representing 0, this is representing 4, this is representing 8, this is representing 9, this is representing 5, this is representing 7, this is representing 13, and this is representing 15. Therefore it is a summation 0 4 5 8 5 7 8 9 13 and 15. So you can clearly see option number, jo statement number Q hai, that is also true. Statement number P is true and statement number Q is true. So directly I can eliminate option number A, I can eliminate option number B. अब मैं ऑप्शन नंबर ए और बी दोनों को एलिमिनेट कर सकता हूँ. नाउ आई हैव टू चेक ऑप्शन नंबर सी, मतलब स्टेटमेंट नंबर आर. सो लेट्स टेक स्टेटमेंट नंबर आर. सो स्टेट नंबर आर सेज दैट वी हैव डब्ल्यू कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट जेड कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस डब्ल्यू एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस एक्स वाई एंड जेड प्लस एक्स वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट एंड जेड. सो जस्ट पुट देयर वैल्यूज. सो दिस विल बिकम जीरो एम जीरो जीरो प्लस दिस विल बिकम वन जीरो जीरो एम प्लस दिस विल बिकम एम वन 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 प्लस दिस विल बिकम एम वन जीरो वन. सो जस्ट एक्सपैंड दिस वैल्यूज. सो दिस इज जीरो 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 प्लस जीरो वन जीरो जीरो प्लस वन जीरो 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 प्लस वन जीरो जीरो वन प्लस जीरो वन 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 प्लस वन 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 प्लस जीरो वन जीरो वन प्लस वन वन जीरो वन. सो दिस वैल्यू इज जीरो, दिस इज फोर, दिस इज एट, दिस इज नाइन, दिस इज सेवन, दिस इज फिफ्टीन, दिस इज फाइव एंड दिस इज 13. सो यू कैन क्लियरली सी अगेन ऑल दिस वैल्यूज आर मैचिंग हियर. सो वी हैव 0, 4, 5, वी हैव 7, 8, 9, वी हैव 13 एंड 15. ऑल दिस वैल्यूज आर मैचिंग. सो पी क्यू एंड आर ऑल दिस थ्री स्टेटमेंट्स आर मैचिंग. सो ऑब्वियसली मे बी दिस इज अ केस दैट एस इज नॉट मैचिंग, राइट? आई हैव टू चेक. तो आप चेक कर सकते हैं यहाँ से एस के लिए. सो वी हैव एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट जेड कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस डब्ल्यू एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस डब्ल्यू कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट कैन बी रिटन एज m 0 0 0 plus this statement can be written as 1 0 0 m plus this statement can be written as 0 m y and m. So ye expand hoga aapke paas yahan par. This is 0 0 0 0 plus 1 0 0 0 plus 1 0 0 0 plus 1 0 0 1 plus 0 0 this y is 1, right? So 0 0 1 0 प्लस 0 0 1 1 प्लस 0 1 1 0 प्लस 0 1 1 1. सो दिस वैल्यू इज 0, दिस इज 8, दिस इज अगेन 8, दिस इज 9, दिस इज 2. सो यू कैन क्लियरली सी 2 इज नॉट कमिंग एनी वेयर हियर एंड दिस इज 3 एंड दिस इज 6 एंड दिस इज 7. तो यहाँ पर जो वैल्यूज आपके पास आ रही है सो आ रही है 0 2 3 6 7 8 एंड 9. सो विच इज नॉट मैचिंग. सो यू कैन क्लियरली सी द करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर डी. ओनली ऑप्शन नंबर डी इज नॉट इक्विवेलेंट टू द ओरिजिनल इक्वेशन. जो ऑप्शन नंबर डी है वो ओरिजिनल इक्वेशन के इक्विवेलेंट नहीं है. आई होप दिस इज क्लियर. नाउ लेट अस लुक एट द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन हियर. दे आर सेइंग डिफाइन द कनेक्टिव स्टार फॉर द बुलियन वेरिएबल्स एक्स एंड वाई एज. तो आपके पास बुलियन वेरिएबल्स एक्स और वाई गिवन है. सो वी हैव एक्स स्टार वाई इज इक्वल टू एक्स वाई प्लस एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट, ठीक है? एंड वी हैव टू डिफाइन स्टार. तो यहाँ से आप देख सकते हो यहाँ पर जो स्टार है दैट इज एक्स एक्स नॉर वाई. एक्स एक्स नॉर वाई जो है वो यहाँ पर गिवन है, राइट? सो जेड इज गिवन एज एक्स एक्सॉर एक्स एक्स नॉर वाई. तो हमें इन सभी की वैल्यूज को निकालना है. सो टेक द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन. सो वी हैव पी विच इज एक्स इज इक्वल टू वाई स्टार जेड. तो यहाँ से आएगा एक्स इज इक्वल टू द वैल्यू ऑफ वाई स्टार. द वैल्यू ऑफ जेड इज एक्स स्टार, दिस इज एक्स स्टार वाई, राइट? एंड वी नो दैट दिस इज रिप्रेजेंटिंग एन एक्सनॉर ऑपरेशन. ये कौन सा ऑपरेशन है? दिस इज एक्स एक्सनॉर वाई. ये एक एक्सनॉर ऑपरेशन है. एंड वी नो व्हेन आई डू एक्स एक्सनॉर एक्स, अगर दो एक्स का एक्सनॉर करते हैं तो वैल्यू इज वन, राइट? एंड एक्सनॉर ऑपरेशन इज कॉम्यूटेटिव. एक्सनॉर जो है वो कॉम्यूटेटिव भी है. सो आई कैन ऑल्सो राइट इट एज वाई एक्सनॉर एक्स एक्सनॉर वाई, विच कैन ऑल्सो बी टेल एज वाई एक्सनॉर वाई एक्सनॉर एक्स, ठीक है? और यू कैन ऑल्सो से इट दिस वे that this is equivalent to this value, which is this is equivalent to y x nor y x nor x. So this value here, this will be equivalent to 1. तो ये हो जाएगा आपके पास 1 x nor x. अगर आपके पास 1 x nor x है, in that case this value will be equivalent to x only. ये जो पूरी value है ये x के equivalent होगी. So the first term p is giving a value which is equivalent to x and that is true. The p statement is true. Now let us look at the Q statement. Q says we have y is equal to x star z, and which is equivalent to x star z, again x star y, which is again x nor operation. ठीक है, तो यहाँ पर क्या होगा आपके पास x x nor x xnor y. If you open it, x xnor y, which is equal to 1 xnor y, and 1 xnor y is equivalent to y only. So second statement is also true. Look at the third statement. Third statement R is saying x star y star z is equal to 1. So here x xnor y xnor, the value of z is basically equivalent to x xnor y, right? So this can be written as x xnor y xnor x xnor y, and because it is commutative, so I can say this value is equivalent to x xnor x xnor y xnor y. So ye jo hai yahan par commutative hai. So I can also write it this way, 1 xnor 1 which is equivalent to 1 only. 1 xnor 1 jo hai wo 1 ke equivalent hota hai. Therefore R is also true. P is true, Q is true and R is true. Therefore the correct answer is option number D, that all three of them are valid. Ye tino jo hai ye valid hai. I hope you can see it's a very very easy question they have asked. Next, if P, Q and R are boolean variables, then simplify this. So we have P plus Q complement, and we have P dot Q complement plus P dot R, and then we have P complement dot R complement plus Q complement. This equation is given to you, right? Now in this equation, how can you solve it? Just open the brackets first of all. So this is P dot Q complement plus P dot R plus Q complement dot P dot Q complement plus P dot R dot Q complement, and which is equal to P complement dot R complement plus Q complement. And you can see this is equivalent to P Q complement. This is equivalent to PR, this is equivalent to PQ complement, and this is equivalent to again PRQ complement, and here it is P complement dot R complement plus Q complement. Now this is repeating two times, ye do bar repeat kar raha hai. Plus here you can apply distributive law, or you can take PR as common. So I can write it as PQ complement plus, if I take PR as common, so it is 1 plus Q complement. तो यहाँ से आपके पास 1 प्लस क्यू कॉम्प्लीमेंट आएगा, एंड दिस इज पी कॉम्प्लीमेंट डॉट आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस क्यू कॉम्प्लीमेंट, विच कैन बी रिटन एज पी क्यू कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस पी आर, एंड हियर वी हैव पी कॉम्प्लीमेंट आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस क्यू कॉम्प्लीमेंट. नाउ अगेन यू कैन ओपन दीज ब्रैकेट्स, आप इसको ओपन करेंगे, सो दिस विल बिकम पी क्यू कॉम्प्लीमेंट पी कॉम्प्लीमेंट डॉट आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस पी क्यू कॉम्प्लीमेंट डॉट क्यू कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस पी आर डॉट पी कॉम्प्लीमेंट आर कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस पी आर dot q complement. So here you can see because of p complement p, this is equivalent to 0, and again this is okay, this equation is okay, but here you can see this also equivalent to 0. So this equation can be written as pq complement plus prq complement. Here you can take pq complement as common, so this is 1 plus r, which is equivalent to pq complement only. So this entire equation can be written as option number a, which is pq complement. In this way you can easily solve this equation, and I hope that you understood, it is such an easy question. Next, they are asking the truth table represents which of the boolean function. Ye kaun sa boolean function ko represent karta hai? So you can clearly see this value is actually equivalent to one value of x only. Ye sirf x ki value ke equivalent hai. So correct answer is option number a. ठीक है, वैसे आप इसको दूसरे तरीके से भी सॉल्व कर सकते हैं. यू कैन ऑल्सो सॉल्व इट दिस वे, जस्ट राइट दिस इक्वेशन, दिस इज एक्स वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट एंड दिस इज प्रेजेंटिंग एक्स वाई, सो इट इज एक्स वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस एक्स वाई, एंड यू कैन टेक एक्स एज कॉमन, सो वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस वाई, सो दैट इज इक्वल टू एक्स ओनली. सो करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर ए, वेरी स्ट्रेट फॉरवर्ड एंड ईजी क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट, विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग एक्सप्रेशन डू नॉट रिप्रेजेंट द एक्सक्लूसिव नॉर ऑफ एक्स एंड वाई. सो वी हैव एक्स नॉर, सो एक्स नॉर इज बेसिकली x y nor x, I mean x y plus x complement y complement. So first one jo hai wo represent kar raha hai. If you take the second one, so here we have x xor y complement, so which is equal to x complement dot y complement plus x dot y complement complement, which is x complement y complement plus x y. So again this is also representing, clear? In the same way अब यहाँ पर चेक कर सकते हैं दैट दिस वन इज ऑल्सो रिप्रेजेंटिंग. सो इवन इफ यू डू एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट एक्स और वाई, सो दिस इज इक्वल टू एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई प्लस एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट, विच इज इक्वल टू एक्स वाई प्लस एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो ट्रू. सो करेक्ट आंसर इज ऑप्शन नंबर डी. इवन इफ यू ट्राई टू एक्सप्लेन, दिस इज एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट एक्स और वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट, सो विच इज अगेन इक्वल टू, सी हियर दिस इज इक्वल टू एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट प्लस एक्स कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई कॉम्प्लीमेंट कॉम्प्लीमेंट, विच इज इक्वल टू x y complement plus x complement y. सो दिस इज नॉट इक्वलेंट टू एक्स नॉर, तो ये एक्स नॉर के इक्वलेंट नहीं है, दिस इज इक्वलेंट टू एक्स एक्स और वाई, ये एक्स एक्स और वाई के इक्वलेंट है. सो दिस स्टेटमेंट डी इज नॉट ट्रू. सो करेक्ट आंसर हियर इज ऑप्शन नंबर डी. डी जो है वो यहाँ पर करेक्ट आंसर रहेगा. क्लियर. सो नाउ लेट अस सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन. नाउ इन दिस क्वेश्चन दे हैव गिवन दैट वी हैव एन एक्सॉर ऑपरेशन एंड वन एंड जीरो डिनोट द बाइनरी कॉन्स्टेंट. नाउ लेट अस सॉल्व इट. सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू शुड नो द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एक्सॉर गेट, राइट? सो लेट मी शो यू द प्रॉपर्टीज. If this is A, this is B, and this is A XOR B. So if these values are 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, so this will be 0, 1, 1, 0. So that means if I do a variable A XOR with 0, agar A ko hum 0 ke saath XOR karenge, so output will be equivalent to A. If I do A XOR with 1, so agar hum A ko 1 ke saath XOR karenge, then output will be A complementation, right? In the same way, if I do A XOR with A, then the output will be equivalent to 0. And we know that XOR is commutative as well as XOR is also associative. XOR jo hai wo commutative bhi hai aur saath saath mein XOR associative bhi hai. So now take this entire equation. We have 1 XOR P, XOR P, XOR Q, XOR P, XOR Q, XOR Q, XOR 0. These are the values that is given, correct? Now from here, if I do 1 XOR P, so 1 XOR P will be equal to P complement. So it is P complement XOR P XOR Q, right? Again, we have an XOR word here. And here, when I say Q XOR with 0, aapke paas jo Q XOR with 0 hai, that is equivalent to Q only. Q XOR with 0 is Q. So this is P XOR Q XOR with Q. Clear? Now from here you can see that when I have P XOR with P complement, P XOR with P complement, this is equivalent to 1. So this is 1 XOR Q XOR, and from this side, from the right hand side, when I do P XOR with Q and Q complement, Q and Q, so this is equal to 0. Now again you can open the bracket. So this is 1 XOR Q. Ab yahan par ye jo value hai, this value is equivalent to P only. राइट, तो यहाँ से आप चेक कर सकते हो दिस वैल्यू इज इक्वल टू पी. सो वेयर इज 1 XOR Q XOR P. सो दिस इज द वैल्यू दैट यू आर गेटिंग. नाउ इन दिस वैल्यू यू कैन क्लियरली सी दिस शुड बी इक्वलेंट टू सेइंग Q कॉम्प्लीमेंट XOR विद P, एंड Q कॉम्प्लीमेंट XOR विद P इज इक्वलेंट टू सेइंग Q XOR विद P होल कॉम्प्लीमेंटेशन. बिकॉज आई हैव सीन, एस वी हैव सीन इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन ऑल्सो, हम पिछले क्वेश्चन में भी देख चुके हैं, वेन एवर वन एनी वन ऑफ द टर्म इन द XOR इज कॉम्प्लीमेंटेड, देन इट इज एक्टिंग एज ए एक्स नॉर गेट. ये एक्स नॉर गेट की तरह काम करता है. वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन. सो द करेक्ट आंसर हियर इज ऑप्शन नंबर डी. सो लेट अस डू दिस क्वेश्चन. कंसिडर द बुलियन ऑपरेशन हैश विद द फॉलोइंग प्रॉपर्टीज, राइट? सो इट इज एक्स हैश विद जीरो यू विल गेट एक्स, एक्स hash with 1 you will get x complement. We have x hash with x you will get 0, x hash with x complement again you will get 1. Then they are asking which of the following statement is true. Ye jo statements hai ye isme se kiske equivalent hai, and you can see this is a very very easy question here. So why it is so easy, let me show you with the help of example. Theek hai, actually these are the properties of direct, which is XOR gate. Ye XOR gate ki properties hai, if you remember the XOR gate in the previous question also we have done. So when you do XOR with same value, then you will get the same value. If you do complement, again this is equivalent to 1. I think this is directly question jisko hum piche kar chuke hain, so I don't really have to solve this question. So correct answer for this problem is option number A. I don't really have to spend a lot of time with this because I know that these are the direct properties of XOR gate. Now they are asking in this question, let x1, x2, x3, x4 XOR is equal to 0, and these are boolean variables, and x this is representing XOR. So which of the following must always be true? Ye inme se charon mein se kaun sa hamesha true rahega? Theek hai, so we know we have x1 XOR, x2 XOR, x3 XOR, x4 is equal to 0. So this value will be equivalent to 0. So let us suppose that we have x1 is equal to 1, x2 is equal to 1, x3 is equal to 1, and x4 is equal to 1. So in that case, this first equation will satisfy. So let us try and put these values here. So first case mein kya hoga, 1.1.1.1 is equivalent to 1. सो दिस इज रॉन्ग. सेकेंड केस में क्या होगा, 1.1.+1=1, सो सेकेंड इज ऑल्सो रॉन्ग. सी आई नो कि एग्जॉर जो है उसकी वैल्यू जीरो कब हो सकती है, राइट. सो इफ ऑल दीज फोर वेरिएबल्स आर वन तो एग्जॉर की वैल्यू जीरो होगी. अगेन वी कैन हैव मोर कॉम्बिनेशन, इसके अलावा और भी कॉम्बिनेशन हो सकते हैं, बट दिस इज द ईजिएस्ट कॉम्बिनेशन दैट आई कैन फाइंड. ये सबसे ईजिएस्ट कॉम्बिनेशन है. सो अगेन यू कैन चेक इन दिस केस ऑल्सो, यहाँ पर आप चेक करेंगे. सो दिस इज वन कॉम्प्लीमेंट एग्जॉर वन कॉम्प्लीमेंट इज इक्वल टू वन कॉम्प्लीमेंट एग्जॉर वन कॉम्प्लीमेंट विच इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो दिस वैल्यू इज करेक्ट. सो सी ऑप्शन इज करेक्ट. And option number D is wrong. So correct answer here is option number C. Now this is the question. Again you can see in this question what they are asking, that हमारे पास कुछ equations हैं and they are asking that which of the following equation is incorrect. इसमें से कौन सी equation incorrect है. It's a very easy example. So it is wx + wx + y + x dot x + y. So this is the left hand side in the first case. So in the left hand side you can take wx is here and you can write it as wx + wy + x + xy, right. Now from these three ye isko aap wx + wy + x + xy likh sakte hain. From here, here and here you can take x as common. So after taking x as common you will get 1 + w + y + w y. And you can see it will be equal to x + wy. So left hand side is equivalent to right hand side. Very easy. आप इसको easily solve कर सकते हैं. Now let us look at the option number B. In option number B we have wx + y + z + whole + w + x. So you can apply De Morgan's law in this. So it is wx + y + z + whole + w + x. So again you can apply De Morgan's law. So it is w + x + y + z + w + x, which is equal to w + x + y + z + w + x. So from this equation and this equation you can take w as common. So this will be equal to 1 + x + xy + z, which is equal to w + x + y + z, so which is exactly matching. So option number B is also correct. Option number B jo hai wo correct hai. So let us take option number C. Option number C ko lete hain. So in option number C we have wx + y + xz + w + x and we have y here. So open the brackets. So this is wx + y + wx + xz + w + x, and here we have y. So this value will be wx + this value will be 0 w + x, and here we have y. So just open the brackets. So this is wx + y + w + x, and again we have y. So this can be from here. So I think I've done some mistake, let me check again. So we have wx + x + z + w + x, right. So here this equation wx + y, this equation will be wx + x + z, this will become 0, and here we have x + w, and this is y. So from this equation we get wx + y + w + x + y, right. तो ये आपके पास दो वैल्यूज आ चुकी हैं. नाउ फ्रॉम दीज टू वैल्यूज यू कैन टेक x + y एज कॉमन. सो इट इज w + w, विच इज इक्वल टू x + y. सो यू कैन सी इट इज xy. सो सी इज नॉट करेक्ट. ऑप्शन नंबर सी जो है वो करेक्ट नहीं है. इन द सेम वे यू कैन ऑल्सो चेक ऑप्शन नंबर डी. सो करेक्ट आंसर हियर इज ऑप्शन नंबर सी. आई होप दैट यू अंडरस्टूड दिस प्रॉब्लम. इट्स अ वेरी वेरी इजी क्वेश्चन. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, लेट दिस इज डिनोटिंग एक्सॉर एंड दिस इज डिनोटिंग एक्सॉर. Then which of the following is not true? This one is true, हमें clearly पता है. And the second statement here, जो second statement आपके पास है आप check कर सकते हो, second statement is also true. The third statement जो है यहाँ पर the third statement here, so which is, see first two statements तो हम लोग पीछे एक question में कर चुके हैं. We have already done those questions, right? So third statement is p XOR q XOR, I think this is also we have done, so this is also true. So we have to check option number D only, because पहले तीन options हम already कर चुके हैं in the same video. इसी video के अंदर हम पहले तीन options देख चुके हैं. Only we have to check option number D. So we have p XOR of p XOR q. So हमें पता है कि when you take p XOR with p complement, this is equal to 1. So this is one XOR with Q, and this will be equal to saying Q complement. ये Q complement के equal होगा. If you look at the right hand side, it is P XNOR with P complement XNOR with Q complement. तो हमें clearly पता है P XNOR with P complement is basically 0 XNOR with Q complement. And ये जो value है 0 XNOR with Q complement, अगर Q की 0 value है तो this value will become 1. So this will become 0, right? तो यहाँ पर ये जो value है, this is I think equivalent to Q, right? So we know if you do 0 XNOR with 1, then you will get a value. So 0 XNOR with 1, then you will get a value 0, and 0 XNOR with 0, you will get a value 1, correct? तो यहाँ पर जो हमें value मिल रही है, अगर Q की value 0 है, तो ये हो जाएगा आपके पास 1. तो 0 XNOR with 1 is 0, right? तो आपके पास वो वैल्यू 0 ही आ रही है, और अगर Q की वैल्यू 1 है तो ये हो जाएगा आपके पास 0, 0 x नॉर 1 इज 0, सो करेक्ट. तो अब यहां पर चेक कर सकते हो, लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज नॉट इक्वल टू राइट हैंड साइड, सो ऑप्शन नंबर डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर. ऑप्शन नंबर डी जो है वो यहां पर करेक्ट आंसर है. ऑप्शन नंबर ए बी सी हम पहले भी चेक कर चुके हैं, तो यहां पर आंसर आएगा ऑप्शन नंबर डी. सो दिस इज द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम गेट 2019. Which of the following is not valid? इसमें से कौन सी statement valid नहीं है? तो you can see the first statement is valid because XOR is associative. XOR gate जो है वो associative है. Now we have to check the second statement. तो पहले second statement को check करते हैं. So it is X plus Y XOR Z. तो ये आपके पास क्या होगा? This is X plus Y whole complement Z plus X plus Y Z complement, right? And which is equivalent to X complement dot Y complement dot Z. And this is X plus XZ complement plus YZ complement. If we take the right hand side here, so right hand side will be X XOR Y plus Z, which is equal to X complement Y plus Z plus, which is X Y plus Z whole complement, which is equal to X complement Y plus X complement Z plus X Y complement and Z complement. And I can see this is, and this is our matching. This is X complement Y is there. So these are not matching. So you can clearly see here, option number B is not matching. Option number B is false. Option number B jo hai, wo false hai. So now let us check the third option here. So third option mein kya hai aapke paas? X XOR Y, which is equal to X plus Y. Theek hai? And we know that X Y is equal to 0. So X Y 0 kab hoga? Ya to X 0 hai aur Y 1 hai. Ya fir X 1 hai aur Y 0 hai. या फिर दोनों की वैल्यू यहां पर 0 है. अब अगर मैं बोलता हूं x XOR y के केस में, तो यहां पर अगर x 0 है और y 1 है, तो इस केस में इसकी वैल्यू होगी 1. सो इन द सेकंड केस, x XOR y के केस में यहां पर जो x की वैल्यू है वो 1 है और जो y की वैल्यू है वो 0 है, तो उस केस में दिस वैल्यू विल बी अगेन 1. और जो फोर्थ केस है यहां पर x XOR y के केस में, x की वैल्यू भी 0, y की वैल्यू भी 0, सो दिस विल बी इक्वल टू 0. तो दिस इज एक्चुअली इक्विवेलेंट टू this, right? So you can clearly see option number C is also correct. So option number A is correct, B is false, C is correct. In the same way, you can also check option number D. So option number D, we know that we have X XOR Y is basically X XNOR Y whole complement, and this is representing X XNOR Y. So clearly see option number D is also correct. So correct answer here is option number B. Option number B is not a valid identity. I hope that you understood all these questions, and we have solved so many previous year gate questions here. And if you like this video, please, if you find this video useful, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, and join our Telegram channel. So Telegram jo channel hai, usko join kare, so that you will get latest notifications regarding our videos. Thank you so much for watching, and we will meet in the next video. Hello everyone. In this video, we will be solving previous year questions from gate computer science. The subject will be digital logic, and the topic will be K-maps. Now let us solve these questions one by one. So the first question is, a boolean function f is to be realized only by NOR gates. The K map is given below. So in the four options we have NOR gates, and they have given the K map. Now how can you implement these gates? So let us do step by step. So first of all, you have to look at what are the max terms here. So we are not going to look at min terms, we are going to look at max terms. So this is a max term, as well as this is also a max term, right? So this is representing A plus B, and this one is representing C plus A, right? Therefore the max term will be a plus b dot c plus a. If you are going to realize this by using OR gates, so this will be your input A and this will be your input B, and I'm going to use an OR gate for them. This is your OR gate, so the output will be A plus B. In the same way, I'm going to use another OR gate. The input will be again A as well as C, so it is going to give us the output, which is C plus A. And now I'm going to use an AND gate here, so the output will be A plus B dot C plus A. Now in this case, I can convert this circuit to a NOR gate. How? I can use a NOT here as well as I can use a NOT here, so there will not be any change in the circuit. I can use a NOT here and I can use a NOT here, again there will not be any change in the circuit. So you can see these two gates here, they are your NOR gates, and this is representing a NOR gate by De Morgan's law. So by De Morgan's law, this gate, you can change this gate to this. So this I can change using a NOR gate like this. So this is the circuit, how you can implement the same circuit by using OR NOR gates. So output will be the same. So which option is matching? Option A is not matching, option B is not matching, option C is not matching, option D is matching. So for this question, the correct answer is option number D. I hope that you understood the question. Let us move on to the next question. This is a very, very easy question here. Next one, they are saying the Boolean function is sum of product where the K map is given below. Now in this K map, they are using a variable entrant map. So they have converted a three variable function to a two variable function by using this variable entrant K map. So we are going to solve this function with the technique of variable entrant. So let us look at this one. So in this case, I can directly tell you the answer here. So telling the answer is very, very easy. So for this problem, first of all, you should know how to convert this using a variable entrant map, or how to solve this variable entrant map. So I'll tell you how to solve this question in two ways. There are two ways of solving the same question. So first way is that you can use the concept of variable entrant. So that is by solving the variable entrant map. And the second method is by expanding all the terms. I'll explain both of them. So let's look at the first part here. So how to solve it by using a variable entrant map. So I'm going to create the same map here. So in the first case, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this A as well as A complement as 0, and I'm going to solve and I'm going to find an SOP. So this is B and this is C. I'm going to take both of them as 0, and this will be 1 and this will be 0. Now I will get an equation for this, right? So here you can see this is representing B complement and C complement. This will be the first term, which is B complement and C complement. Now next time I'm going to take this variable A, and I'm going to take this variable A as 1 and other variables are 0. So for variable A, I can solve it this way. I'm going to put this variable A as 1, and I'm going to put this A complement as 0 and any 1 to not, don't care, right? So from here I can get this equation, which is representing BC. So this is the term which is representing BC, right? In the same way, I can also solve for this A complementation, this A complementation. So what I'm going to do here in this case is I'm going to put A complement as 1, A as 0 and 1 as don't care. And again, I'm going to try and find the expression. So here you can see this will be your subcube, which is possible. And this subcube is representing C complementation. Therefore, the equation will be, here I'm going to combine A with it. So the equation will be A, B, C plus, here I'm going to combine it with C complement. So A complement, C complement plus B complement and C complement. So this will be your solution for this given question by using the method how you solve variable entrant maps. So as you can see, it is a very, very easy method and just need a few seconds to solve this problem. Second way is by making the table. So I'm going to make a table here. This is the variable B, this is the variable C, and this is the function f. So what they are trying to say is that whenever this b and c both are 1, so this function is f is giving a value 1. Whenever b is 0 and c is 1, in that case function is giving a value 0. Whenever b is 1 and c is 0, in that case the function is giving a value a complement. And whenever b is 1 and c is 1, in that case the function is giving a value a. Now you can create, you can expand this function completely for all these variables, which is a, b and c, and this is your function f. So whenever this function bc is there, right? So here if a and b can have any values, so the function f is taking a value 1 in both the cases. So this bc can have a value which is 0, 1. When this 0, 1 is value is there, so function f is giving a value 0, 0, even if a is having a value 1 or 0. Whenever this bc is having a value 1, 0, in that case function f is giving a complement, right? So here a complement means this will be changed to 1 and this will be changed to 0. And in case of 1, 1, this function f is behaving just like a, so that means whatever the value of a is, that will be the value of function f. Now you got the complete function. Now I can make a k-map for this. For a 3 variable function, I can easily make a k-map. So here this is a and this is bc. So this is a complement and a, this is b complement c complement, b complement c, bc and bc complement. Now in this case you can see what are the locations where the function is assuming a value 1. So at this location the function is having a value 1, and this location is representing a b complement c complement, which is this location, and this location is representing a value a complement b c complement, so which is this location, and this location is representing this value. So you can now make subcubes here. So this subcube is representing a value which is b complement c complement. Now this subcube here, it is representing a value which is a b c, and this one can be combined using this. Aap in dono combine kar sakte hain. So after combining both of them, this will give us a complement and c complement. So again equation we will get is a b c plus b complement c complement plus a complement and c complement. So you can see, you can get the same answer from both the cases. Exactly the same way you can solve this problem easily. Now let us look at this next problem. What is the equivalent minimal Boolean expression for the following k map? So a k map is given. Now I have to find the equivalent Boolean expression for this. It's very, very easy, as you can see, one of the easiest question that you can ever come across, very straightforward question. So this is a subcube which is possible, as well as all these ones will create one subcube. So this subcube is representing D and B, and this subcube here, it is representing B complement and D complement. So the equation will be B complement D complement plus BD, which is equal to B XNOR D. So this entire K map is representing the term B XNOR D. It is so easy, as you can see, right? There's no doubt in this. The easiest question that ever come across in gate examination. So in this question, they have given a K map, and they're saying what is the equivalent Boolean expression in the product sum form of the K map? What is the Boolean expression that you can have? So here this is a subcube which is possible. This will be one subcube, and you can also have this as a subcube. So there are two subcubes are possible. So this subcube is representing a value which is D complement, and from here it is B. So it is B D complement, correct? And I think this is right. So it is B, and from here it is D complement, right? And this subcube is representing a value which is D as well as B complement. So we get B D complement plus B complement D, which is B XOR D, right? But as you can see, this is actually matching with the option number A. So if SOP is asked, because this is a product, sum of product, if sum of product is asked, then option number A will be the answer. But the problem is they are asking product of sum. They are not asking sum of product. They are asking product of sum, or you can say POS expression. So because they're asking POS expression, so I'm going to take all these zeros, right? So for POS expression, this will be a subcube, as well as all these corner zeros will make another subcube. So this subcube is representing the product term, which is D complement plus a b complement, and this corner one is representing the product term, which is your d complement, and we have it is representing d plus b. So you can see, if you combine it, so it is b plus d dot b complement plus d complement, which is representing the option number c. So option number c is the correct answer for the one this given question. I feel that this is again an easy question. The thing is, you should not miss the term product of sum, because they're asking product of sum. Many times people make mistake, they ignore such things, so you cannot miss those problems things, right? Now what is this question? They are giving us a k map. Now this one very interesting thing here, what they have done is, instead of writing 1 1 here, they have written, they have interchanged these two columns, right? So because they have interchanged these two columns, because of that 90% students will make mistake in the examination, because they will think that this will be a subcube, but you can see this will not be a subcube, because you have to see these things very carefully in the examination. Now here you can see this will be a subcube as well as this will be a subcube. We cannot have that bigger subcube. So this subcube is representing the term which is BC, and this subcube is representing the term B complement C complement, which is BC plus B complement C complement, that is representing B XNOR C. But if you know the property of XNOR, XNOR is basically a complement of XOR. So this can be written as B XOR C whole complement, which is matching the option number C. So option number C is the correct answer for this problem. Now let us look at this next question. Which of the following function implements the k-map shown below? So we have four functions. Let us first solve the k-maps, and then we will see later on. So here this can be a subcube, as well as this can also be a subcube. So I have created two subcubes here. So this subcube is representing the value a and d, and this subcube is representing a value which is c and d. So that means I should get ad plus cd. I can take d as common, so it is a plus c dot d. So again, very easy question, very straightforward question. You can never get a question which is easier than this. Very easy question for gate exam, very easy question. Now which function does not implement k map given below? Which of these function is not implementing the above k map? So you can see, for this k map there are many different outputs are possible, right? So let me go through all the outputs one by one. I can make this subcube, and secondly I can make this subcube. So these two subcubes are possible. So this subcube is representing the value xy, and this subcube is representing the value y and w. Therefore it will be xy plus wy. So xy plus wy is basically representing your option number b, as well as it is also representing your option number a. So it is wy and this is xy. So option number a and b both are same, and option number a and b can be implemented very easily. But can we implement this option number c? Kya aap option number c ko implement kar sakte hain? Can we implement this option number c? So you can see, this option number c is basically your POS expression, that is product of sum expression. So we have to make product of sum from this k map. I can make this bigger subcube, as well as I can use this subcube. This will be very very big subcube, as well as I can also make this one, right? So if I make this subcube here, so your term will be only y, right? And nothing else will come. And if I make this subcube, so your term that will come is going to be your x plus w. Therefore the term that will come is x plus w dot y, again which is matching with option number a, right? So basically option number a, they wanted to give a product of sum expression. This is what they wanted to give, a sum of product expression, right? So obviously option number a and b are possible, but still, can we make option number c? So in option number c, you can see that all this product term are having two variables, right? I mean two literals in each of this product term. So that means I have to make a subcube maximum of size 4. Can I get a subcube of maximum of size 4? Yes, I can. How I can do that? So I can make a subcube like this here. I can make this as a subcube, correct? as well as I can make this as a subqueue, correct? As well as I can make this as a subqueue. So because all three of these subcubes are of size 4, I'm not making a size 8 subqueue, because here all these terms are basically your size 4 terms. So this one is representing the term which is x complement plus y. This subcube is representing a term which is y plus w, and this one is representing a term which is x plus w. Okay, so this is y, I think, yes, y plus, and here this will be here it will be w is there, na? So it is w complement, y plus w complement. So that means I will get a term which is x plus w dot x complement plus y dot w complement plus y, which is option number C. Therefore option number C is also matching. So that means A, B, C and all of them are matching. Okay, so all of these can be implemented. Therefore the correct answer will be option number D. So all three of them can be implemented and they are asking not implemented, right? So option number D jo hai, that will be a correct answer for this given problem. Now let us look at next one. Given the following K map, which of the following represents the minimal SOP for this K map? Minimal sum of product expression jo hai, what will be the minimal SOP? So you can see SOP they are asking. So I can make a subcube here as well as I can make a subcube here. It's very easy, the easiest question. So this subcube is representing y complement z, and this subcube is representing y, and we have x. Therefore it is y complement z plus yx, which is equal to y complement z and yx. As you can see, option number A is directly matching. Very easy and straightforward question. You cannot not get a question which is easier than this. Very easy question. Again, minimum sum of product, that is SOP expression for this function in the given K map. What is the SOP expression for this given function? As you can see here, I can make this as a subcube as well as I can make this as a subcube. So there are two subcubes are possible. So this subcube is representing a term which is z complement dot x, and this subcube is representing a term which is z dot, and the second term that is not changing is x complement. So it is z complement x plus x complement z, which is x, x or z, and this is matching the option number B. So option number B is the correct answer for this given problem. Next, the literal count of the Boolean expression is the sum of number of times each literal appears in the expression. For example, the literal count of this expression is 4. So here 1, 2, 3, 4. So every time you have a variable, you have to count is a literal. So there are 4 literals here. What is the minimum possible literal count of the product of sum and sum of product representation respectively for the of the following given of the function given by the K map? So here X represents the don't care condition. So they're asking what is the minimum number of literals in product of sum as well as sum of product expression. Okay, so product of sum and sum of product expression, what is the minimum number of literals you can have? So let us first take your SOP. Okay, so in case of SOP, what are the subcubes you can make? You can make all these corners as one subcube, fine, and then you can make this as another subcube, and then you can also make this as another subcube. So there are 3 subcubes are possible. So here this outer subcube is representing a value which is the value that is not changing is y complement dot, second value is w complement, right? And this subcube is representing a value which is your x complement z complement w, and this subcube is representing a value which is z complement w complement, and we have x. Therefore the expression will be x z complement w complement plus x complement z complement w plus your y complement and w complement. This will be your expression. Now you can see in this expression the number of literals. So yahan par jo literals hain, so how many literals are there? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So there are total of 8 literals in SOP expression. SOP mein total 8 literals hai. So you can see in none of these options, kisi bhi option ke andar, we do not have 8 as the answer. The closest possible answer is 9 or 10, right? So we do not have 8 in the answer. So you can see that means the options given in this question, they are wrong. But again, let us also figure out what is the number of literals in product of some expression. We know here that SOP expression is containing 8 literals, but let us look at POS expression, that is product of some expression. So in case of your product of some expression, we can make these subcubes, we can make this as a subcube, this is a subcube which is possible, and a part of this we can make I can use all of them here, this is also a subcube which is possible, and I can use this as a subcube, as well as I can use this as a subcube. So these subcubes I'm using. Now using this subcube is giving us a value which is your x complement plus y, and this subcube is giving us a value which is x plus y complement plus w, and this subcube is giving us a value which is w complement plus z complement plus x complement, right? And this subcube is giving us a value which is your what is this value, this is your y complement plus, and this value is z complement, right? So what is the expression? The expression is x complement plus y dot x plus y complement plus w dot w complement plus z complement plus x complement dot y complement plus z complement. So here number of literals, how many literals will be there? 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. So there are total of 10 literals in this expression. There are total of 10 literals in this expression. But is it possible that a product of some expression is possible even less than 10 literals? Kya 10 literals se kam product of some expression possible hai? Yes, that is also possible. How can we make an expression which is even having less than this much? So what you can do is you can combine this subcube of size 4, you can combine this subcube again a subcube of size 4, and then you can also make this subcube again, this is also a subcube of size 4, and then you can make this subcube which is a subcube of size 2. So here you can see we have created 4 subcubes here. So this subcube is representing a value which is x complement plus w complement, this subcube is representing a value which is y complement plus z complement, and this subcube is representing a value which is w complement plus z complement, and this subcube is representing a value which is your x plus y complement plus w. Therefore the expression will be x complement plus w complement dot y complement plus z complement dot w complement plus z complement dot x plus y complement plus w. So if you count the total number of literals, so it is 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9, so there are total of 9 literals. So that means in POS expression we are getting 9 literals, in SOP expression we are getting a total of 8 literals. So none of these answers are matching. So either I can maybe say in examination I will skip this question, because again I can say that none of these options are correct. But even if I have to mark option, then I can say option number C is the closest one to the answer. Option number C jo hai wo answer ke sabse close hai. So either I can mark option number C. I will not be able to mark option number A, because at least in option number C one option is matching. Only one option is matching, so I can mark option number C. Now is there any short trick to count the number of literals? Kya number of literals ko count karne ke liye koi short trick available hai? See, this kmap is of 4 variables, so the number of variables is 4. So whenever you are going to create a subcube, so according to the size of subcube, it is going to reduce the number of literals in that particular expression. For example, this subcube is of size 4. 4 means it is 2 raised to power 2. So that means I'm going to subtract this 2 from this number 4, so which is 4 minus 2 is equal to only 2. So that means this subcube is going to give us 2 literals. Is subcube se hame 2 literals milenge. So you can see what are those literals, so which is x complement plus we have w complement, so only 2 literals are there. So in the same way, even if you have POS expression or even if you have SOP expression, any expression whatsoever, so for example I can make in this case I can make a SOP expression here. Let us suppose this is your SOP expression, right? So this is your sum of product expression. For this sum of product expression, the size is 4, so which is again 2 raised to power 2. So if you are going to create any, SOP expression or minterm from this, so that minterm will be having only 2 literals. So us minterm ke andar sirf 2 literals honge. So you do not really have to calculate the entire expression, just like I have calculated entire expressions here. I do not really have to calculate the entire expressions. Without even calculating also, I can solve the same question. Now let us look at the next question. The Boolean function for a combinational circuit with 4 inputs is represented below. Now, which of the following product terms given below is an essential prime implicant of the function? So if you have an implicant, which if you have a prime implicant which is covering a term that is not covered by anyone else, that is called as your essential prime implicant. So first of all, let us see what are the implicants that are possible here. So we can have this as an implicant. Ye ek implicant possible hai. Let me just change the size. So this is an implicant. A part of this, we can also have this as an implicant. Then we can have this as an implicant. Then again we can have this as an implicant. Then again here we can have this thing as an implicant, and again we can make this last one. I can combine all the corner ones together, so I can combine all of these corner ones in one. So this, this, this and this to make a huge subcube. So you can see this can also be covered here. So this huge subcube, this will be your essential prime implicant. Why? It is covering two terms, that is, it is covering one term that is not covered by anyone else, right? It is covering this term. Let me show you the term also. This is the term which is not covered by anyone else. Okay, I guess I can also cover it with someone else. Okay, so I can cover that one. Okay, let me make again. So here I can make all these corner ones together. I can make a subcube with all these corner ones. And a part of this, I can make the following subcubes also. I can make this as a subcube. I can make this as a subcube. And a part of this, I can also make this as a subcube. I can make this as a subcube. I can also make this as a subcube. Main yahan par isko bhi ek subcube bana sakta hun. And in the same way, I can combine. I think this is a subcube I can make. So I think the corner one here, that will be your essential prime implicant. So because that is a prime implicant which is not a part of any other implicant, plus it will be your essential prime. So this blue one here, the corner ones, that is your essential prime implicant here, right? So your corner is representing a essential prime will be of size 2. It will be a size 2 because it is containing 4 elements. What are those 4 elements? 1, 2, 3 and 4. So it is containing 4 elements. So the size is 4, which is 2 raised to power 2. So you can see here that we have 4 variables. Out of 4 variables, I have created, I'm going to eliminate 2 variables because of this. So the size will be 2. So just by looking at this, you can eliminate option number A, B, C. You can see option number D is the correct answer. But again, if you want to find the value of this corner one, so the value of this will be Q complement and X complement. Okay, so you do not really, you know, have to get answers just by the formulas or numbers. You can say the option number D will be a correct answer because the biggest subcube that is possible here, that biggest subcube is essential prime. Jo yahan par sabse bada subcube hai, wohi essential prime hai. Aur sabse bade subcube ka size hai 4. So because the biggest subcube is having a size 4, that is why out of 4 terms, I'm going to remove 2 terms. So your min term will be having 2 terms only. Okay. Next question. Consider the following expression. Which of the following k-maps currently represents the expression? Isme se kis k-map se hame ye expression milegi? Now you can see in all of these k-maps, they are only giving us a don't care. We are only having a don't care. We are not having any 1 and we are not having any 0. So let us look at the first k-map here. So in the first k-map, I can make different subcubes. I can make this as a subcube, as well as I can make this as a subcube, as well as I can also use this as a subcube, right? So if I'm using this subcube, so this subcube is representing the term which is A, and the next term is D complement. This subcube is representing a term which is A complement and C complement, and this subcube is representing a term which is your C complement D and we have B. So the expression will be A complement C complement plus A D complement plus C complement DB. So check with the options. So here A D complement, it is coming, A complement C complement is coming, and B C complement D, it is coming. So that is why option number A is the correct answer for this problem. The first option was correct. Okay, I hope that you understood this very easy question. Next, consider the following expression. Which of the following expression does not correspond to the K map obtained for the above expression? Is expression se jo kaun sa aisa expression hai niche jo iske K map ko represent nahi karta. Okay, so let us make this expression first of all. Is expression ko hum log sabse pehle banate hain. So here it is having four variables A, B, C and D. So there are four variables. So my K map will be containing a total of four variables. So this is your K map. Okay. It will be having a total of four variables. This is variable AB and this is variable CD. So it is A complement B complement, A complement B, A complement B. Then AB and this is AB complement. This is C complement D complement, C complement D, CD and CD complement. Now in this case, this is AD complement. So wherever we have AD complement, I'm going to put up one. So where are the locations where you have AD complement? This is A and D complement, as well as this is A and D complement, as well as this is also A and D complement, and this is also A and D complement, right? Second term will be your A complement C complement. So A complement C complement, here we have A complement C complement, and here also we have A complement and C complement. Third term will be B C complement D B C complement D. So B C complement D will be this term. This term is there, B C complement D. Now I've got this K map, and for this K map I have to tell which of the expression is matching. Now let us look at this one. So what are the subcubes that are possible here? Kaun kaun se subcube possible hai? So I can have, okay, first option se match karte hain. So here we have C complement D complement. So C complement D complement is this subcube. This subcube is representing C complement and D complement. Second is A D complement. So A D complement, we have A and D complement. So A D complement is basically this subcube. This is A D complement. Third is ABC complement. So we have A, B and C complement. You can see here that do we have ABC complement? A is here, B is here and C complement is here. So that means we are making this subcube. So this subcube is representing your A, B and C complement. Okay. In the same way, the last term is A complement, C complement, D. And you can see that this subcube is representing A complement, C complement and D. Therefore, you can see option number A jo hai, it is possible. Option number A can be created using this K map. So option number A is possible. So let us look at the option number B. So we'll figure out is option number B possible or not. Anyways, so is option number B possible or not? In option number B, we have C complement, D complement. So obviously it can be created. We have A complement and C complement. So A complement and C complement is basically this subcube. This subcube is your A complement and C complement. So this is also possible. Then we have A D complement. So A D complement, A D complement, A D complement is this subcube. So this subcube, I think it is representing A D complement. Okay, this is A D complement. And then we have A B C complement D, and you can see this is representing A B C complement D. So option number B is also possible. Option number B can also be done with it. Option number B ko bhi aap bana sakte hain. Okay, I hope that you understood this part. Okay, now check out the option number C. So in option number C we have A complement and C complement. So A complement and C complement is this subcube. This is your A complement and C complement. Then we have the second term is, let me just rub it. Right, so here the second term is A D complement. So is there anyone here, is there A D complement here? A and D complement, A and D complement. So you can see I can make this subcube, and this subcube is representing A D complement. Third term representing A B C complement. So we have A B C complement. So in this case we have A is here, and we have B. So B is, so A B C complement, right? So A B is here and C complement is here. So I can make this subcube, which is A B C complement, I guess, right? So A B and C complement, right? And then the fourth one is C complement D. So C complement D, as you can see here, I think we cannot make C complement D. So yahan par C complement D is not possible, correct? So yes, C complement D is not possible. So I'll say option number C cannot, we cannot make. I can do option number A, I can make option number B, as well as I can make option number D, but I cannot make option number C because of this term. This term is not possible here in this diagram. Let us look at the next question. In the K-map shown below, X denotes the don't care. What is the minimal form of the functions represented by the K-map? So they're asking what the minimal SOP is possible, because in all the options they are giving SOPs only. So what is the combinations that you can make? You can combine these two, okay, as well as you can combine all these four corners. So these two subcubes are possible, that's it. So this subcube, this corner subcube, is representing a value which is D complement, and we have a B complement. And this black subcube is representing a value which is your D complement as well as your A complement. So we have A complement, D complement, plus B complement and D complement. So which is matching with the option number A. As you can see, very easy question. Option number A is the correct answer. One of the easiest questions that you can ever come across for GATE. Next. What is the minimal form of K-map shown below? Assume that X denotes the don't care combination. So all the options here are giving SOP. So I'm going to find a sum of product expression for this, or you can say SOP expression for this. So I can combine all these four corners, right? A part of this I can combine these two. So only two subcubes are fine. So obviously I can remove option number D, I can remove option number C because it is having four terms, right? So I can remove option number A also, very easy. I can directly say that option number B will be the answer even without calculating their values. But again, let me calculate the values here. See, because here two subcubes are possible and size of both the two subcubes is 4. So obviously both the terms should have two literals, right? So here you can see this corner one is representing the term which is D complement, and we have a B complement, this corner one. And this pink one is representing the term which is C complement, and we have a B complement, right? So that is why you can see option number B is directly matching. So that is the correct answer for this given question. Then this is a K-map. They are saying consider the K-map given below, and they're asking the blank represents 0, assuming all the inputs A, B, C, D respective complements A complement, B complement, C complement, D complement are also available. The above logic is implemented using a two input NOR gates. The minimum number of gates required is, for this question, what is the minimum number of gates that are required? So first of all, let us try and solve this question. This question ko solve karte, let us try and minimize this expression. So we can make this subcube, and there's no need of making any other subcube. So this subcube is representing a value which is C as well as A complement. So we have C A complement, right? So that means we have to implement C A complement. We have to implement C A complement using the two input NOR gate. Using the two input NOR gate. NOR gate, right? So we have to implement this function. Okay. So how will we implement? How can we implement? So they are saying their complements are also available. This is very interesting. They are saying assuming that all inputs A, B, C, D are available, as well as their complements are also available, you can directly give complement as an input, right? So that means this A complement C can be written as, if you take A complement C, it can also be written as A plus C complement whole complement, right? So by De Morgan's law, this can be written as A complement dot C. So I can implement this using a NOR gate. I can use this NOR gate here, and in this NOR gate I can directly give A and I can directly give C complement. So that means only one NOR gate is required to implement this circuit, right? So here this term is very important here, as you can see that complements are also available. Agar complements available nahi hote, then in that case you need two NOR gates, because the complements are also available. So that is why aapko sirf ek NOR gate ki hi requirement hai. Now they are saying consider the four variable functions. Aapke paas functions hain f1, f2, f3 and all these are four variable functions. Now which of the following circuit with AND gate and one XOR gate input function can be expressed. To isme se ye kaun sa function jo hai yahan par represent kar raha hai, right? To let us figure it out. To pehla jo function hai yahan par, jo f1 function hai, so f1 is representing the values which is 0 2 5 8 and 14, right? Let me write it clearly. So f1 function is representing a value which is 0 2 5 8 and 14, and f2 function is representing a value which is 2 3 6 8 14 and 15. So when I'm going to use the AND gates, so that means I'm taking the intersection, so only those values will come which comes in the intersection. So 2 and 2 is common, so 2 will come here, and here you can see that 8 and 8 is common, so therefore 8 will come here. 14 and 14 is common, therefore 14 will come here, right? So only these three terms will come, and f3 is 2 7 11 and 14. Now I'm using exclusive OR. So exclusive OR means that I'm going to get those values which is available in one and not available in another, right? So because we know in case of XOR, when we have 1 and 0, then only it is having a value 1, or 0 and 1, then only it is having a value 1. So we have to search those values which is available in one but not in other. For example, 2 is available in both of them, so XOR will not give this answer. 7 is only available in F3, so 7 is going to be here. 8 is only available in this function, not in other function, so 8 will also be here. 11 is only available in this function, not with other, so 11 will come here. And 14 is not is available in both of them, so the output will be summation 7 8 and 11. 7 8 and 11 will be your output. So correct answer is option number A. As you can see, very easy question, and maybe you are not going to spend a lot of time in examination based on this very very easy question. And I hope that you liked the video. If you liked it, please hit like button and share it with your friends. Have a nice day. If you guys are ready, we can start our session. And this is supposed to be comparatively easier session, because here we will be looking at some of the previous questions related to multiplexers. Now agar aapko ye video useful lage, if you find this video useful, please subscribe to the channel, like, hit like on the video, and you can join our Telegram group. As you can see here, this Telegram group, whenever I make a new video, I post the latest notification of that new video in the Telegram group. Plus I share a lot of study materials and content and practice papers in Telegram channel. So aap latest information ke liye please Telegram group ko join kare. And if you want to take our courses, please visit our website, which is www.digimento.com. So I hope that you will find this video useful. So let us start. So this is the very first question. They are saying the output F of the below multiplexer circuit can be represented by, what will be the output of this circuit. So as you can see here, we have the input is A and second input is B. So here we have to pass the following values, which is 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1. Okay, so if you take give 0 0, that means if I have A complement and B complement, then I will get the output as C. If I get 0 1, that means if I have B complement A, in that case I will get the output as C complement. Plus if I have 1 0, that means if I have B and A complement, in that case we are going to get the output as C complement. Plus if I have 1 1, that means in that case if I have AB, then I will get the output as C. So this is your equation. As you can see, this equation is not matching with any one of these options. So that means we may have to try and minimize this equation. So let us rearrange all the variables. So we have A complement B complement C, plus A B complement C complement, plus A complement B C complement plus A B and C. These are the variables which are available. Okay, now I can try and take any two terms here, but you can see this is very interesting because maybe you'll not be able to take something in common. So what I can do is I can try A complement, I try and taking A complement as common from here. So this is going to be B complement C plus BC complement plus I can try and take A as common from here. So it will be B complement C complement plus BC. So if you look at this term is basically a complement of exclusive OR. So I can write A complement B complement C plus BC complement plus A dot, this is B exclusive OR C whole complementation. Therefore you can see this is A complement B exclusive OR C plus A B exclusive OR C whole complement, so which is again equal to A XOR B XOR C. So this entire situation, this entire equation is equivalent to option number B only because we are taking XOR of all three of these variables. Hum tino variables ka yahan par XOR le rahe hain. It is a very easy question, as you can see, comparatively easier to anyone else. Okay, so second is show with the help of block diagram how the boolean function AB plus BC plus CA can be realized using a 4 cross 1 multiplexer. We have a 4 cross 1 multiplexer, but if you look at this function, so you will say, sir, this function here, it is having 3 variables, so that means the number of input in the multiplexer should be 8, so it can be realized using 8 cross 3 multiplexer. But obviously yes, we can also realize it using 4 cross 1 multiplexer by using variable entrant. Aap variable entrant ko use karke you can realize the same circuit using a 4 cross 1 multiplexer. So how can we do it? Let us try and see this example. Okay, so here in this case, when you are looking at this given example, there are two ways. Either you can take this function and you can try and make the truth table with this. You can try and make the truth table with it. Or second way is you can try and find out a shortcut method to implement this. I'll explain both of them. Okay, so let me explain you the shortcut method first and then I'll explain the total proper method so that you will be able to follow through the example. So this function says that we have AB plus BC plus CA. This is the following function. Now this function can also be written as AB plus A complement BC plus AB complement C. The same function can also be written in this manner. So if the same function can also be written in this manner, in that case what I can do is I can simply use a 4 cross 1 multiplexer. This is a 4 cross 1 multiplexer which is having 4 inputs, and this is having A and this is having B and this is your output, right? So our output is AB plus A complement BC plus A B complement C. What do I mean to say by this is that if we have AB, so that means in that case if both inputs are 1 1, in that case I'm giving the output as 1. If I have A complement B, A complement means if I have 0 1, in that case the output is C. If I have A B complement, that means if the input is 1 0, in that case the output is C. And if I have A complement B complement, then in that case the output will be 0. So here I can say the output is 0. So in this way, in a shortcut manner, you can easily implement this function. But let me explain you how I came to this solution. So that is a complete solution with the help of a truth table. So this is the variable A, this is B, this is C, and the possible combination here, they are 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1. This is your function. Now in this function we have AB plus BC plus CA. That means wherever we have a variable A and B as 1, in that case I'm going to get a value as 1, right? So here we have a variable AB as 1, so in both these two cases we are having a value 1. Wherever we have B and C, so as 1, So B is 1 as well as C is 1 here. So this is going to be 1, as well as you can see here also B and C are 1. Therefore, this is also going to get a value 1. And third one is CA. So wherever a value of C and A are 1, so you can see C and A are 1, as well as here also C and A are 1. So this is how you are going to make a truth table for this. So I got the truth table. So using this truth table, I'm going to create a variable entrant. So in that case, I'm going to use variable A, I'm going to use variable B, and this is the function F. So the combinations are 00, 01, 10, and 11. Now you can see here that in these combinations, when A, B are both 0, in that case, function F is giving a value 0. When A, B are 0, 1, the function F is giving a value which is equal to C. When the A, B are 1, 0, in that case, the function F is giving a value which is equal to C. And when AB are 1, 1, in that case, the function F is behaving like 1. So you can clearly see how can I easily implement it. So it doesn't matter if you know the shortcut or not. You can still do the same question with the help of this proper method. It will not take you lot of time. Zyada time nahi lagega. But this will be a better method. You will not be making any mistakes with it. Aap is method se mistakes ko create nahi karenge. You will not be making any mistake. But sometimes when you are using a shortcut method, in that case, there's a high chances that you are going to make mistakes in the examination. But with a proper method, long cut method, you will never be making any kind of mistakes. Dekho, in your examination, even if you are giving a GATE examination or even if you are giving a UGC NET examination, in any of these examinations, you are never going to have short of time. I mean, in UGC NET might be having a short of time, but in GATE you'll never be having a short of time. Let me explain you this thing if you are already in this topic. Dekho, in GATE you get approximately 65 questions. Out of these 65 questions, you will be having 10 questions which are from aptitude and reasoning, and you will be having approximately 55 questions which are from technical section. Out of these 55 questions, you will be having 25 questions from which are of 1 marks, and you will be having approximately 30 questions which are of 2 marks, and you have a total time of roughly 3 hours. 3 hours means which is equal to 180 minutes. Okay, in 10 aptitude questions, you have 5 questions which are of 1 marks, and you have 5 questions which are of 2 marks. This is how the exam distribution is. Now, in this exam distribution, you will find that solving these 1 marks question is very, very easy. It is hardly going to take 2 to maximum 3 minutes to solve these 1 marks question on an average. Here also, you are going to take 2 to 3 minutes on an average to solve these 1 marks question. So if I'm taking 2 to 3 minutes, let us suppose even if you are taking on an average 3 minutes to solve these questions, that means you are going to take approximately 75 minutes to solve this these questions, right? And you, if you are going to solve these 32 marks question, so how much time will be remaining? So approx you will be having 2 hours, right? So because here again it is going to take 10 minutes here, so roughly you are going to take 60 minutes to approximately 90 minutes in just solving 1 marks question. Aap ek marks se questions mein 60 se lekar 90 minutes lenge. Therefore, your 2 marks question, jo aapke paas 2 marks ke jo question hai, that will suppose to take approximately 120 minutes to again 90 minutes. But it is better if you can solve 1 marks question within 60 minutes, it can be easily done. Agar aap 2 marks question ko 60 minutes mein kar sakte hain, I mean 1 marks question ko 60 minutes mein kar sakte hain, in that case your 2 marks question will get approximately 120 minutes, and 120 minutes will mean you will be having a total time of approx 4 to 5 minutes, right? So approx 3 to 4 minutes to solve the 2 marks question, right? Plus there will be some question which can be solved within 1 or 2 minutes. Kuch questions aise honge jo zyada time lenge, but again on an average you will get lot of time in solving these questions. Bahut time milega aapko, and you can see you will never be a short of time. I mean time shortage kabhi bhi nahi hogi. But in UGC NET you might be having a short of time when you are giving a UGC NET examination. In that case you are going to have total of 100 questions, and you are having approximately 100 questions, and you are having approximately 2 hours, which is equal to 120 minutes. So UGC NET examination is more about speed. Yahan par negative marking nahi hai, we do not have a negative marking. it is about speed, and your gate examination is about quality. So the kind of questions in GATE are very quality questions, which are very, very good questions, and because they are supposed to think that you are going to have enough time. So GATE examination is more like CAT, right? So where you are always going to get a quality questions, as well as you are going to get enough time to solve these questions. But UGC NET examination is more about your MAT, right? So which they used to take for MBA in local colleges. So here the kind of questions are comparatively easy as compared to GATE, plus the time is going to be less. So here approximately you will get 1.2 minutes to solve a question, or even if you are solving like 60 questions out of 100, so you will take approximately 2 minutes per question. So that means the rest of the 40 questions you are going to guess the answer, right? So guessing will also be there. Guessing also plays an important role in UGC NET. So if you can solve 60 questions correctly, then rest 40 questions you can start guessing, and still you will be able to qualify the examination, right? So you can see UGC NET is more about speed and GATE is more about quality. So if you are preparing for UGC NET, it is better that you should solve each and every questions many times. So if I'm giving you this multiplexer questions, so jo multiplexer ke questions hai, you have to solve these kind of PPTs and the questions in approximately 6 to 7 times before the examination, because that will help you to create the speed. Usse aapko ek speed milegi, right? It will help you to have a speed. So if you can have a speed, maybe you will be able to solve more number of questions in less amount of time. So dono question examinations mein there's a difference. There's a fundamental difference here. So UGC NET supposed to be little difficult as compared to GATE, but again UGC NET is for assistant professors. So assistant professors are supposed to solve these questions very easily. For example, when I make my videos, I make my solution videos, you must have seen that I make my solution videos very fast, because it doesn't take me a lot of time to solve these questions. Hardly I spend 1 or 2 minutes to solve the questions as well as to explain, right? It doesn't take me a lot of time to explain and solve these questions because of practice, right? That is why it takes so much time. So if you can really practice, if you can really spend some time in practice, if you can really understand these topics, you will not take a lot of time. But again, as because you are studying the topic for the very first time, you can take some time and, you know, spend some time in the questions. Okay, so let us take the next year all tips, other tips at some other time. Baki tips, some tips hum kabhi aur dekhenge. So let us try and solve this given question. Okay, so what they are asking is, consider the circuit F. I think have I solved this question. This is the question from GATE 1996. Let me check if I have solved this question. This question I have solved, this question also I have solved. Okay, let me check. I've solved this one, I have solved this one, I have not solved this. So this is a GATE 1996 question. Okay, so let us do this question here. So in this question, you can see we have a following multiplexer is given. Now in this multiplexer, the inputs are C, C complement, C complement and C, and they are giving the select lines. So we have select line 1 and select line 2. So they're asking what the function F is implementing. So there's one mistake here. The mistake is that they have not given what is A and what is B. So they should have given that if select line 1 is A or if select line 2 is B and so on, these things should have been given. So anyways, if it is, let us assume that select line 1 is representing A and select line 0 is representing B. In that case, if I have A complement B complement, then I will select C. If I have A complement B, then I will select C complement. If I have A B complement, then I will select again C complement, plus if I have A B, then I will select C. So in this case, again, you can easily figure it out, this solution. From here, you can take A complement as common. So this is B complement C plus BC complement. And from here, you can take again A as common. So this is B complement C complement plus BC. And you can again easily figure out this is representing an XOR gate because we have already solved it. So this is B. This one is B XOR C. This is B XOR C plus this is B XOR C whole complementation, which is equal to A XOR B XOR C. The correct answer is option number C. It is so easy, such an easy question. In the examination, you will never face any difficulty. Okay. Next, a multiplexer with a 4-bit data select input. So that means in your multiplexer, you are having a select line which is of 4-bit. Right? 1, 2, 3, 4. So you have a 4-bit data select line. Then how many inputs will be there? I always told you if a number of select lines are n, then number of inputs are 2 raised to power n. So here the number of select lines are 4. Therefore the number of inputs are 2 raised to power 4, which is equal to 16. So it will be a 16 cross 1 multiplexer. The correct answer is option number C. Very, very easy question. Next, consider the circuit shown below. Now, the output of 2 cross 1 multiplexer is given by the function AC complement plus BC. So the output is AC complement plus BC. Okay. This is AC complement plus BC. Now they are asking which of the following is true. Okay. So this G, what will be this value of G? So the value of G will be X1 complement dot 0 plus, let me also write it clearly, this is AC complement plus BC, this is given in the question. So this G is basically representing X1 complement dot 0 plus X1 dot 1, which is equal to representing X1. So jo G hai, so G is representing X1 only. Theek hai? So this is G is representing X1. So X1 complement dot 0 plus X1 dot 1. Theek hai? So which is equal to this is equal to X1. So G se jo hai, hum X1 ko represent kar rahe hain. Fine. So we are representing X1 here. So that means here I've taken X1 as input. And here, is it really X1? Just check. G is representing X1. So is there any mistakes here in the question? Oh, so there's a mistake in the diagram actually. So there was a mistake here in the diagram. I've seen this question again. So there's a mistake in the diagram. So what the mistake is, this value is actually 1 and this value is 0. That is why I was thinking that there's something wrong with the question. So in this question, this value is 1 and this value is 0, right? So if you see, what is the equation for G? So G will be x1 complement dot 0 plus x1, so x1 complement dot 1 plus x1 dot 0. This value is equal to 0, therefore G is equal to x1 complement. This will be the value of G. So here in A I have given x1 complement, and here in B I'm just giving x1, right? Therefore the equation f for the function is going to be what is this equation? Equation is going to be that is x2 complement dot x1 complement plus x2 dot x1, so which is representing your x1 xnor x2. So the correct answer for this given question is option number C. Option number C should be the correct answer for this given problem. Okay, so what they are asking, what does this equation mean? That one of this input is C, one of this will be called as A, one of this will be called as B. So that means whatever the output these will be giving, whatever the output G or F will be giving, that output can be written as AC complement plus BC. So they have given this output. Now they have also given what is the inputs here, what is the input that they have given. Now according to that, you have to find the value of the function F. So F will be X1, XNOR, X2. Very easy question. The only thing here is that in this question, this is a mistake here and this is also a mistake. So this value should be 10. Then the correct answer is option number C. Next question. Here, consider a multiplexer with X and Y as data inputs. So aapke paas X aur Y jo hai wo data input hai, and Z as the control input. So Z is equal to 0, select X. Z is equal to 1, select Y. What is the connection required to realize two variable boolean function f is equal to t plus r? without using any additional hardware. So what does they are, what are they saying? That this is your multiplexer, this is a 2x1 multiplexer. In this 2x1 multiplexer you have control input as Z, and here if I say Z is equal to 0, in that case you have an input X. If I say Z is equal to 1, in that case we have in this input Y, okay, and this is your output. Now they are saying that this output function F is actually representing T plus R. You have T plus R in this output function F. Now they are asking what should be these inputs of X and Y. So X or Y ke jo input hai wo kya hone chahiye so that we can get T plus R. Okay, so let us check the option number A. So we'll check option number A. They are saying R to X. So in this variable X, I'm going to give R. 1 to Y, so here I'm going to give 1, and T to Z, here I'm going to give T. So in that case, what is the equation? Equation will become T complement dot R plus T dot 1, which is equal to T complement dot R plus T, which is distribute T complement plus T dot R plus T, and this is representing a value 1, therefore this will be T plus R. So you can see option number 1 is correct. Now let us assume that option number 1 was wrong. In that case you have to insert this value of option number 2. So option number 2 was saying that in T you have to pass the value X, in R you have to pass the value Y, it means that in place of X I'm going to pass T, this is option number 2, right? In place of Y I'm going to pass R, in place of Z I'm going to pass T. Again, by passing these values you can compare the options, but anyways we found the option, the first option itself was correct. So correct answer is option number A for this problem. Okay, clear sabko? The next question here is they are giving a circuit here. So they are saying the circuit shown below implements a 2 input NOR gate using a 2 to 4 multiplexer. Control signal 1 selects the upper input. What are the values of the X, Y and Z? So X, Y or Z ki values yahan par kya hongi? तो यहाँ पर क्या है, सो दिस इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. दे आर सेइंग कंट्रोल सिग्नल 1 सेलेक्ट्स द अपर इनपुट. अगर आपके पास कंट्रोल सिग्नल की वैल्यू 1 है, इन दैट केस योर अपर इनपुट विल बी सेलेक्टेड. सो दैट इज़ व्हाई दे हैव गिवन 1 0. इसी वजह से यहाँ पर इन्होंने 1 0 दिया है. सो इफ यू लुक एट दिस ऑप्शन, सो दिस इज विल बी ए जेड प्लस बी जेड कॉम्प्लीमेंट. यहाँ पर ए जेड और बी जेड कॉम्प्लीमेंट है, दिस इज वॉट वी आर गोइंग टू गेट. In the same way, if you look at the equation for this output, so equation for this output will be AZ plus BZ complement should select the output X, plus if I have AZ plus BZ complement should select the output as Y. So in this case, our output Y select hona chahiye. Okay, itna clear so far. So if you say, if you represent this output of the first function represented by F, agar first function ka output F se represented hai, to iska matlab hai this output can also be represented F dot X plus F complement dot Y. To jo output hai F dot X plus F complement dot Y ke equal hona chahiye. Theek hai, but this is what the output should be. Theek hai, now what we are getting here, हमें जो आउटपुट मिल रहा है दैट इज ए प्लस बी होल कॉम्प्लीमेंटेशन. हियर द आउटपुट इज ए प्लस बी होल कॉम्प्लीमेंटेशन. सो टेक दिस इक्वेशन, द इक्वेशन इज ए जेड प्लस बी जेड कॉम्प्लीमेंट एक्स प्लस ए जेड प्लस बी जेड कॉम्प्लीमेंट होल कॉम्प्लीमेंट वाई. दिस इज व्हाट इज गिवन. सो इफ आई नीड ए प्लस बी होल कॉम्प्लीमेंटेशन, अगर हमें a प्लस बी होल कॉम्प्लीमेंटेशन चाहिए, इन दैट केस लेट अस अज्यूम दैट इफ आई टेक x एज 0, अगर मैं x की वैल्यू को 0 लूंगा, इफ x इज इक्वल टू 0, इन दैट केस दिस इक्वेशन विल बिकम, दिस एंटायर इक्वेशन विल बिकम 0. सो आई विल गेट ए जेड प्लस बी जेड कॉम्प्लीमेंट होल कॉम्प्लीमेंट डॉट y, राइट? सो किस केस में, इफ x इज इक्वल टू 0, अगर x की वैल्यू 0 है तो आपके पास ये जो है इक्वेशन इसके इक्वल हो जाएगी. ठीक है, इतना क्लियर है सबको. नाउ लेट अस अज्यूम दैट इफ आई टेक y इज इक्वल टू 0, इफ सो y इज इक्वल टू 1, I have taken x as 0. If I take y is equal to 1, in that case this equation will be az plus bz complement whole complementation dot 1. So y is also eliminated. So I found that value of x should be 0 and the value of y should be 1. Now in this equation, the equation finally we got is az plus bz complement, and from this equation I want to get the answer, which is a plus b. So hame jo output chahiye, so the output that we want is a plus b whole complementation. So if I want a plus b whole complementation, what should be the value of this z? This is a tricky part. Is z ki value kya hona chahiye ki hame a plus b whole complementation mile. So what you can do is, let z should be equal to a. Agar z ki value a hai, in that case what will happen, this is a dot a plus b dot a complement whole complement, which is equal to a plus a complement b whole complement. If you apply distributive law, so this is a plus a complement dot a plus b whole complementation, and this term is equivalent to 1, so this entire function will be equal to a plus b whole complementation. Okay, so that means in that case, that means that your value of x jo hai aapki, the value of x should be equal to 0, the value of y should be equal to 1. X ki value 0 honi chahiye, y ki value honi chahiye aapke paas 1, and the value of z should be equal to a. Now there are two ways of solving this question. Is question ko solve karne ke do tarike the. There are two ways. So the first way that I have already told you, जो फर्स्ट वे है वो मैंने आपको ऑलरेडी बता दिया है. तो व्हाट इज द सेकंड वे? सेकंड वे इज यू कैन गो टू द आउटपुट डायरेक्टली. तो फर्स्ट आउटपुट इज सेइंग कि आपके पास x की वैल्यू 1 है, y की वैल्यू 0 है और z की वैल्यू b है. सो बाय टेकिंग दीज वैल्यूज चेक आउट व्हाट इज द आउटपुट. इस केस में हमारे पास आउटपुट क्या आता है. सेकंड इज द सेकंड ऑप्शन इज x की वैल्यू 1 है, y की 0 है और a की z की a है. सो गिव दिस आउटपुट इनपुट एंड चेक करो इज द आउटपुट इज मैचिंग विद दिस. अदरवाइज give this input which is 0, 1 and b, and then check the output is matching with that also. ठीक है, तो आपको करना ये है. सो वॉट यू कैन डू इज यू कैन डायरेक्टली गो विद द ऑप्शन. आप ऑप्शन को यहाँ पर इंसर्ट कर सकते हैं. यू कैन इंसर्ट द वैल्यूज ऑफ द ऑप्शन एंड देन यू कैन गेट द आंसर. आप ऑप्शन की वैल्यू को इंसर्ट करेंगे, अगेन उससे भी आपके पास आंसर आ जाएगा. इज इट क्लियर सो फार? सो नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, सपोज ओनली वन मल्टीप्लेक्सर एंड वन इन्वर्टर आर अलाउड टू यूज टू इम्प्लीमेंट allowed to be used to implement any boolean function. आपके पास सिर्फ एक मल्टीप्लेक्सर है और एक इन्वर्टर है. इन्वर्टर मीन्स इट इज़ अ नॉट गेट. आपके पास एक नॉट गेट है टू इम्प्लीमेंट एनी बुलियन फंक्शन ऑफ एन वेरिएबल्स. वट इज़ अ मिनिमम साइज ऑफ द मल्टीप्लेक्सर नीडेड. उस केस में आपके पास जो मल्टीप्लेक्सर है उसका साइज कितना होना चाहिए एट मिनिमम. ठीक है, सो वट शुड बी द मिनिमम साइज ऑफ द मल्टीप्लेक्सर? देखो, इफ यू हैव अ नॉट गेट, अगर आपके पास एक नॉट गेट अवेलेबल है, सो इफ यू हैव अ नॉट गेट और कैन से वन इन्वर्टर, इन दैट केस वी कैन क्रिएट अ वेरिएबल एंट्रेंट. तो उस केस में हमें वेरिएबल एंट्रेंट की रिक्वायरमेंट है. इफ दिस नॉट गेट इज नॉट अवेलेबल, अगर ये नॉट गेट अवेलेबल नहीं होगा, देन वी नीड 2x1 मल्टीप्लेक्सर. नाउ बिकॉज दिस इन्वर्टर और दिस नॉट गेट इज अवेलेबल, इफ दिस नॉट गेट इज अवेलेबल, देन वी विल बी नीडिंग 2n-1x1 मल्टीप्लेक्सर. उस केस में हमें 2n-1x1 मल्टीप्लेक्सर की रिक्वायरमेंट होगी. ठीक है, क्लियर सो फार? फाइन. सो द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस प्रॉब्लम शुड बी ऑप्शन नंबर सी. ऑप्शन नंबर सी जो है वो इस क्वेश्चन का करेक्ट आंसर होगा. राइट, सो लेट अस मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन हियर. Okay, so very interesting question. You are asking how we can do it. So I'll take an easy example and then maybe I'll explain you. थोड़ा सा मैं easy example लूँगा और मैं आपको explain करता हूँ. Fine. So let us assume that we have the following function which is ABC. आपका function ABC है. This is a function. So the combinations are 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 0 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 and 1 1 1, assuming this is your function. ठीक है, now in this case let us give some random values to this function. आप इनको कुछ भी random values कर सकते हैं. okay, let us give some random value to this function, kuch bhi random value, you can give any value whatsoever. So let us take the values as 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, and we have 1, 0. This is some random values. Mm. Okay, mm. I have taken these values randomly. Randomly. Okay. So, first of all, I have to create a variable entrant for this. Iske liye sabse pehle hum variable entrant banayenge. This is A, this is B, and this is your function F. So, when A, B both are 0, and this function F is behaving like C only. When A and B both are 0, 1, then function f is behaving like c. When a and b both are 1 0, the function f is behaving like again c. When a and b both are 1, in that case the function f is behaving like c complement. So in the multiplexer, this is your multiplexer, which is your 4 cross 1 multiplexer. In that case your input will be c and c complementation, and here it will be a b, and this is your function f. So in this case of c complement, I have to use this not gate. उस केस में हमें नॉट गेट या फिर इस इन्वर्टर का यूज़ करना पड़ेगा. आई हैव टू यूज़ दिस इन्वर्टर और यू कैन सी नॉट गेट टू फाइंड आउट दिस सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट. ठीक है, इस सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट के लिए हमें इन्वर्टर या नॉट गेट का यूज़ करना पड़ेगा. बट व्हाट इफ समथिंग लाइक दिस हैपन्स, अगर इसकी जगह पर इनपुट कुछ ऐसा होता दैट आई हैव कॉम्प्लीमेंट इन मेनी ऑफ द लोकेशंस. आपका जो कॉम्प्लीमेंट है वो काफ़ी लोकेशंस पर है. इफ़ द फंक्शन इज समथिंग लाइक दिस, वी हैव 0 0, वी हैव 1 0, वी हैव 1 0, एंड हियर वी हैव, लेट अस अज्यूम 0 1. अगर आपके पास ये फंक्शन है, सो इन दैट केस दिस वैल्यू गिव अस 0, दिस विल बी योर सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट, दिस विल बी अगेन योर सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट, एंड दिस विल बी अगेन योर सी. सो हियर व्हाट विल द इनपुट, इनपुट विल बी 0, दिस विल बी सी, एंड फॉर बोथ ऑफ देम आई कैन टेक सी, आई कैन अप्लाई नॉट गेट, एंड दिस विल बी योर सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट. नाउ दैट्स इट, वेरी इजी. नाउ यू कैन सी द इनपुट विल बी गिवन एज सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट, हियर द इनपुट दैट विल बी गिवन एज सी कॉम्प्लीमेंट. सो यू कैन ओनली, यू ओनली नीड वन नॉट गेट. आपको इम्प्लीमेंट करने के लिए आपको सिर्फ एक नॉट गेट की रिक्वायरमेंट है, या फिर ओनली वन इन्वर्टर टू इम्प्लीमेंट दिस 3 वेरिएबल फंक्शन. आई मीन दिस इज 8 x 1 मक्स यूजिंग अ 4 x 1. तो आप इस तरीके से इसको इम्प्लीमेंट कर सकते हैं. इज इट क्लियर सो फार? एनी डाउट प्रियंका? Is there any doubt with you? It's an easy question. The only thing is that you should remember the basics. Next question is, the following circuit implements a 2 input AND gate using a 2 x 1 multiplexer. तो आपको यहाँ पर एक AND gate को implement करना है. So 2 input AND gate. ठीक है. So they're asking, but should be the values of x1, x2 and x3. आपके पास x1, x2 और x3 की values क्या होंगी? To do that, first of all, I should get this equation. मुझे इसके लिए equation बनानी पड़ेगी. So the equation will be x1 dot a plus x1 complement dot b. So यहाँ से जो equation मिलेगी, that is x1 dot a plus x1 complement dot b. And for this output, ये जो output आपके पास है, the equation for this output will be your x3 dot x1a plus x1 complement b plus x3 complement dot x2. So this output function f for this equation is x3 dot x1a plus x1b plus x3 complement dot x2. This is what the output is. अब हमें इसको किसके इक्वल करना है? वी वॉन्ट टू हैव एंड गेट. आपको यहाँ पर सिर्फ एंड गेट की तरह इसे इम्प्लीमेंट करना है. सो व्हाट यू कैन डू इज यू कैन पुट द वैल्यूज ऑफ x1, x2 एंड x3. तो सबसे पहला ऑप्शन नंबर ए है, इंस्टेड ऑफ x3 यू आर पुटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ a, इंस्टेड ऑफ x1 यू आर पुटिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ b, इंस्टेड ऑफ x2 यू आर पुटिंग अ वैल्यू एज अगेन 0. So just put this values for option number A and you can see whether it is matching with the answers or not. तो आपके पास यहाँ पर क्या आएगा? This is A, this is BA plus x1 complement which is B complement dot B plus x3 which is A. So this is A complement dot 0 which is equal to A BA plus this value is 0 plus this value is again 0 which is BA dot A which is equal to BA. So you can see option number A is matching and you are getting the output as AB or BA which is your AND gate. तो आप यहाँ से भी एंड गेट को इम्प्लीमेंट कर सकते हैं. क्लियर सो फार? एनी डाउट इन दिस? क्या अब तक किसी को कोई भी डाउट है इसमें? So it's very easy. All you have to do is get the equation for this output and then try and insert these values. Output ki equation lijiye aur in sabhi values ko insert karne ki koshish kijiye, then you will be able to understand very easily. Theek hai? Yes, Novla, in examination, just to trick you, वो आपको trick करने के लिए, they can give that first is representing 1 and second is representing 0. So most of the time people think that first will be 0 and second is 1. Just like in the previous question, I thought that first will be 0. But in examination, वो जानबूझ के इसको change कर सकते हैं, they can change this so that you make mistakes in the examination. ठीक है? Consider two cascade 2 to 1 multiplexers shown below. The minimal SOP of the product of form of the output X. आपको X के लिए minimum SOP बतानी है. So you can see here they have given 0 and 1. So that means this output will be P complement dot 0 plus P dot R, which is equal to PR. तो यहाँ से जो output मिलेगा आपको मिलेगा वो PR. Therefore the equation for X will be X complement dot Q complement dot R complement plus Q dot PR. Right, so this is your equation, which is Q complement dot R complement plus Q dot PR. Okay, is it matching with any of the options? Yes, it is matching with option number D. So option number D is the correct answer for this given problem. Okay, so for now we have solved all the questions PYQ related to the multiplexers in gate. अब तक जो भी gate में questions पूछे गए हैं multiplexer के, तो वो अभी हमने सॉल्व कर लिए हैं. आई डोंट थिंक सो दैट यू गाइज आर हैविंग एनी डाउट विद इट. मुझे नहीं लगता कि आपको इसमें से कोई भी डाउट होगा, बिकॉज ऑल दीज क्वेश्चंस आर वेरी इजी. हेलो एवरीवन, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल बी सॉल्विंग सम प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन काउंटर्स फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट डिजिटल लॉजिक. एंड इफ यू फाइंड दिस वीडियो यूजफुल, प्लीज लाइक द वीडियो एंड सब्सक्राइब टू द चैनल. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन सेज द नंबर ऑफ फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स रिक्वायर्ड टू कंस्ट्रक्ट अ बाइनरी मॉड्यूलो n counter. Now in this question they have not clarified what kind of counter is it. Is it a ring counter? Is it a Johnson's counter? Or is it an asynchronous counter? They have not specified in this question. Why? Because in case of a ring counter, when you need a total of mod n, for mod n you need a total of n फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स. आपको मॉड n के लिए टोटल n फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स की रिक्वायरमेंट होती है. व्हेन यू यूज अ जॉनसन्स काउंटर, इन जॉनसन्स काउंटर टू डू मॉड 2n यू नीड अ टोटल ऑफ n फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स. आपको 2n के लिए, आई मीन 2n काउंटिंग स्टेट्स के लिए यू नीड टोटल ऑफ n फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स. एंड व्हेन यू आर यूजिंग अ सिंक्रोनस काउंटर, इन दिस केस टू परफॉर्म अ मॉड ऑफ 2 रेज टू पावर n you need a total of n flip-flops. तो यहाँ पर 2 power n counting के लिए आपको n flip-flops की requirement है. For example, if I want to create a mod 8 counter, right? So in case of a ring counter, to perform 8 countings, that is mod 8, you need 8 flip-flops. In case of a Johnson's counter, you will be needing 4 flip-flops. And in case of an asynchronous counter, you will be needing only 3 flip-flops, because every flip-flop will be representing 1 bit of information. So because they have not asked anything in this question, so this question is in a state of confusion. But if I want to answer this question in the examination, I will be saying that you need for asynchronous circuits, because in asynchronous circuit to perform a counting of 2 raised power n, you need a total of n flip-flops. That means the number of flip-flops that can be required, you can take a log of 2 raised to power n base 2 ceiling value, that will be equal to the number of flip-flops that are required. So here they're asking modulo n. So modulo n will be log of n base 2 ceiling value. These many flip-flops will be required to perform this counting. Okay. So this will be the answer that I will be giving for this given question. Then look at the next question. They are asking how many pulses are needed to change the content of a 8-bit up counter from this number to this number. The rightmost bit is the LSB. So yahan par jo rightmost bit hai wo least significant bit ko represent kar rahi hai. So first of all you should know the difference between an up counter and you should know the difference between a down counter. So what is this up counter and down counter? In case of up counter, we start counting from 0 to up, I mean in the ascending order. So that means you can do countings like this: 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and again you can start from 0. That is your up counter. And in case of a down counter, we do counting in the descending order. So in case of down counter, we'll be having 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, and again we can come back to 7. So they're asking about a up counter first of all. So it should be clear what is the difference between an up counter and a down counter. Now again, in this up counter as well as in this down counter, so with these up counters we are going to create using a synchronous flip-flop. So this is asynchronous flip-flop, right? So with this asynchronous flip-flop, if we have a total of n flip-flops, with these n flip-flops there will be total of 2 raised to power n states, or you can say the modulus of the flip-flop will be mod of 2 raised to power n. This we have seen in the previous question itself. Isko humne previous questions mein humne check kiya tha. Now if you look at this question here, they're asking how many pulses are needed to change the content of 8-bit up counter from this number to this number. So basically this is an 8-bit up counter. That means in this counter we are using a total of 8 flip-flops, because every flip-flop is going to store 1 bit of information. Hence for 8 bit of information you need 8 flip-flops. So it will start counting from 0. It will start counting from 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. And again the next one number will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Next number will be 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. And so on. It will count till the last, which is this combination. So this combination is representing a number 0. This combination is representing a number 1. This is representing a number 2. And this combination is representing a number 255. So that means it will do a counting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to so on 255, and after again 255 it will reset and it will start from 0. Now from this counting they have given us two numbers here. The first number is 10101100 and the second number is 00100111. So that means you have to convert this number from binary to decimal, right? So this is 2 to the power 0, 2 to the power 1, 2 raised to power 2 plus 2 raised to power 3 plus 2 raised to power 4. This is 2 raised to power 5 plus 2 raised to power 7. So this is 128 plus 32 plus 8 plus 4. So 128 plus 32 is 60, and 60 plus 12 is 172. So this number is representing 172 here. Okay. And if you count this number, this is representing 2 raised to power 0 plus 2 raised to power 1 plus 2 raised to power 2 plus 2 raised to power 3, 2 raised to power 4, 2 raised to power 5. So this is going to be 32 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1, and this number is basically 39. That means we have to count from 172 to 255, and after 255 it will again reset to 0, and then from 0 to 39 we have to go. Okay. So between this 172 to 255, what is the number of countings we are going to do? So you can subtract this value. So 255 minus 172, that is going to be 83, plus you are going to add this number, which is 255 to 0, which is 1, plus from 0 to 39, it is again 39 countings. So if you add this number, so this is going to be 83 plus 40, which is equal to 123. So basically here you are going to count, you are going to need 123 pulses. You need to count 123 times so that you can reach up from here to here. So correct answer for this problem is option number D. Okay. I hope it is clear with all of you. Look at the next problem. Consider the following circuit diagram, its realization by JK flip-flop. So we got a circuit diagram here, and we got that they want to realize this circuit diagram using the JK flip-flop. Now they're asking the combination circuit generates JK in terms of X, Y and Q. So this is X, this is Y, this is Q, and here we'll be having Q complement. The Boolean expression for JK are as follows. I mean they want to know this expression for this given circuit. तो इस सर्किट के लिए उनका एक्सप्रेशन चाहिए. सो हाउ कैन यू डू इट? फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल लेट अस मेक अ स्ट्रेट ट्रांजिशन टेबल फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर डायग्राम. सो टू क्रिएट अ स्ट्रेट ट्रांजिशन टेबल यू नीड व्हाट इज द करंट स्टेट, व्हाट इज द इनपुट. ठीक है, सो आई एम गोइंग टू राइट क्यू एक्स एंड वाई एंड देन आई कैन फाइंड व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट स्टेट व्हिच इज क्यू एन प्लस वन एंड देन आई कैन फाइंड व्हाट इज द इनपुट टू जे एंड के. And how can I find this input to J and K? For this, I'm going to use, for this input, I'm going to use the excitation table. For this, I'm going to use the excitation table. Okay? So, if you can see this diagram, if your current state is Q, which is 0, and your input is 0, 0, agar aapka current state 0 hai, and input aapka agar 0, 0 hai, so your next state is again 0. Okay? In the same way, by looking at, you can easily figure out if your current state is 0, if your current state is 0 and the input is 1, 1, so your next state is again 0. Aapke jo agli state hai, wo fit se 0 hai. Okay? In the same way, you have to fill this entire table. But let me fill this entire table in a proper order. So this is 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1. 110 and 111. Why I try to fill this in this proper order? Because in that it will make it easy for me to perform the calculations. Okay? So if your current state is 0 and the input is 01, then the next state is 1. If your current state is 0 and the input is 10, the next state is again 1. If your current state is 0 and the input is 11, so next state is again 0. Okay? If your current state is 1 and the input is 00, so next state is also 1. If your current state is 11 and the input is 01, then the next state is 0, and for 10 again the next state is 0, and for 11 the next state is 1. So you have to find these values and then you have to fill this table. So how I created this table? I have created this table using this straight transition diagram that they have given. So jo diagram inhone given hai, isi ki help se maine is straight transition table ko banaya hai. Now using this straight transition table, I want to find this Q and Qn plus 1. So Q or Qn plus 1 ki value ko main use karunga. And I'm going to use this excitation table for JK flip-flop. Theek hai? For JK flip-flop, if you remember the excitation table, we have Q, Qn plus 1 and this is the value of J and K. So this is 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So the J value of J and K will be 0, 1, don't care and it is don't care, 1, 0. This is the value of JK flip-flop. I think we have already covered this in the classes itself, right? Now here you can see in the first case from 0 we are transitioning to 0. Present state is 0 and the next state is also 0. So which is this case? So I'm going to write 0 don't care in this case. So we get 0 don't care. In the same way in the next case from 0 I'm going to 1. So if you look at from 0 I'm going to 1. So the value of JK will be 1 and don't care. In the same way I'm going to fill this entire table. So if you fill this entire table you'll get the values 1 don't care, then 0 don't care, then don't care 0, don't care 1, don't care 1 and don't care 0. I'm going to use this excitation table to fill this table for J and K. Correct. Now what I can do is I can make a k map for the input of j. Hum j ke input ke liye k map bana sakte hain. In that k map I'm going to use q, x and y, and for k also I'm going to create a k map. To sabse pehle I'm going to create a k map for j and then I'm going to create a k map for k. This is the k map for k. Now for the k map for j, I'm going to take q here and x and y here, and here also q here and x and y here. So that means this is representing q complement q, this is x complement y complement, x complement y, x y and x y complement. This value will be q complement q, again x complement y complement, x y complement, sorry this is x complement y, x y and x y complement. Okay? So I have to look at these values where j is assuming a value 1 and what are the locations j is assuming a value don't care. In the same way for k also I have to take these values and I have to fill this table. Okay? For j I will get these values don't care, don't care, don't care and don't care. We have a value 1 here as well as we have a value 1. So in these two cases j is having a value 1. And for k If you look at these values, so this is don't care, don't care, don't care, and don't care, and it is having two values, two location, it is having a value 1 here and here. In these two locations, it is having a value 1. Now you can see we can make a subcube here, we can make a subcube here. Here I'm going to make a subcube, here I'm going to make a subcube. So this subcube is representing x complement y plus this subcube is representing x y complement. This subcube is again representing x complement y plus this subcube is representing x y complement. That means from both of these subcubes I'm getting x xor y. Okay. So that means in this combinational circuit, in this entire combinational circuit, let me show you how the circuit will be looking like. So in this combinational circuit, I'm going to take exhaust. I'm going to take this x, I'm going to take this y, I'm going to find an xor of this x and y, and I will give this xor to j as well as I will give this xor to k, and that's it. So if you look at the options here, the option number D is correct. Option number D is matching with the answers that we are getting. So correct answer for this problem is option number D. Okay. Look at the next problem. The minimum number of D flip-flops needed to design a mod 258 counter. So again, they're asking for mod 258 counter, and they're not telling what kind of counter is it. Is it a synchronous counter? Is it an asynchronous counter? So I'm going to assume that it is an asynchronous counter. And to create a mod 258 counter, I have to take log of 258 base to ceiling value. So if you take log of 258 base to ceiling value, that will become 9, right? So that means 9 bits are required to count these many numbers, as well as you are going to require 9 flip-flops. Aapko har ek bit ko store karne ke liye ek flip-flop chahiye. So you are going to write 9 flip-flops. So the correct answer will be option number A. Very easy problem, straightforward and direct problem. Now look at this problem here. Let k is equal to 2 raised to power n. A circuit is built by giving the output of a n bit binary counter as an input to a 2n to 2 raised to power n bit decoder. What is the circuit equivalent to? So what do they really want to say is that I'm going to have a counter here, and this counter is your n bit counter. Okay, and the value of n can be anything. So let us take n is equal to 2. Agar n ki value 2 hai, so I'm going to use this counter. In this counter I can use any flip-flop. Maybe let us suppose let it is D flip-flop here, and here also D flip-flop, and this counter is having some kind of connectivity. ठीक है, कुछ कनेक्टिविटी है इन फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स के बीच में. सो इट मे बी एनी काइंड ऑफ कनेक्टिविटी वेट कैन बी देयर. नाउ दे आर आस्किंग द आउटपुट ऑफ दीज डी फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स आर गिवन एज इनपुट टू अ डिकोडर. ठीक है, बिकॉज इट इज अ 2 बिट काउंटर, सो डिकोडर इज 2x4 डिकोडर. सो इन दिस डिकोडर वी हैव अ टोटल ऑफ 4 स्टेट्स, करेक्ट. Now what they are asking is the circuit is given by the output of n bit binary counter as an input to a n into 2 is power n bit decoder. Okay, this circuit is equivalent to which of the following? Okay, now let us assume that it is an asynchronous counter again. Okay, so because they are asking, they are telling that it is an n bit binary counter, that means with help of n I can count 4. I mean it is a mod 4 counter. Okay, so the combinations can be 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1. So that means here the input can be 0, 0 or the input can be 0, 1 or the input can be 1, 0 or the input can be 1, 1. So if the input is 0, 0, if the input is 0, 0 to this decoder, then out of these four outputs, output 0, output 1, output 2, output 3, agar input aapka 0, 0 hai, in that case the output will be 1000. So it will be 1000. Okay, if the input is 01, in that case the output will be 0010. If the input is 10, the output will be 0100. If the input is 11, the output will be 1000. Okay, so basically if you look at it here very carefully, if you look at it here very carefully, your input, right, this is an n bit binary counter. It is an n bit binary counter. Okay, n bit binary counter, and in this n bit binary counter this decoder is counting 0001, then it is counting 0010, then it is counting 0100, then it is counting 1000, and then again it is counting 0001. Okay, So basically here you are using 4 bits. In the output we are having a 4 bits and we are having 4 states. Okay, so we are having 4 bits in output and we are also having 4 states. So if you remember it, I told you that in this case there are 3 kinds of counters are present. Maine aapko sabse pehle bataya tha in the very first question itself. So you can have 3 kinds of counter. You can have a ring counter, you can have a Johnson counter, and you can have a asynchronous counter. In case of a ring counter, you have n bits and you have total of n states. In case of Johnson counter, you have a n bit and you have a total of 2n states. In case of a asynchronous counter, you have n bits and you have a total of 2 raised to power n states. Okay, in this case, in this output you have 4 bits and you have 4 states. Aapke paas 4 bit hai aur 4 state hai. Therefore it is basically acting as a ring counter. Ye aapka ring counter ki tarah act kar raha hai because you have 4 bits in the output and you have 4 states. So if you look at these options, so I will say that option number C is the correct answer for this problem, and because it is acting as a ring counter here, to ye ring counter ki tarah act kar raha hai. Clear so far? So let us move on to the next problem here. So they are asking, consider a 4 bit Johnson counter with the initial value of 00. I mean 4 times 0. There are 4 bit Johnson counter. So because it is a Johnson's counter and it is a 4 bit Johnson's counter, then it is going to count 2 into n, which is equal to 2 into 4, or you can say it is a mod 8 counter. Ye aapka mod 8 counter hoga, so which is going to count from 0 to 8. Now what is the counting sequence of this counter? Sequence is counter ka counting sequence kya hoga? So first of all, let us make a Johnson's counter. Let us make a Johnson counter. So how does this Johnson counter look like? We are going to have 4 flip-flops, and in Johnson's counter we use D flip-flop in most of the time. So we have a D flip-flop here, we have a D flip-flop here, we have a D flip-flop here, and we have a D flip-flop. And these Johnson's counter are basically synchronous counters, because your ring counter and Johnson counter both are synchronous. Ring counter or Johnson counter dono synchronous hote hain. Therefore they are going to have a common clock. In sab ki common clock hogi. And this Johnson counter is also called as twisted ring counter. Johnson counter ko hum twisted ring counter bhi bolte hain. I mean, what is the difference here? The output of this will be given as input to this, the output of this will be given as input to this, the output of this will be given as input to this, and here in the last state the Q complement is given as input to D. This is what we have. Now they are saying that the initial values here are 0 0 0. That means here we have 0, here we have 0, here we have 0, and here the value of Q is 0. So the Q complement will become, this Q complement will become 1, because initial value is 0 0 0, so Q complement will become 1. So what will happen from 0 0 0 0, the next state will become 1 0 0 0. Why? Because this one will travel from here to here and all these will start shifting. So here this will become 1, this will become 0, this will become 0, this will become 0, and this will again remain 1. So ye aapka 1 rahega. So the next state that we are going to have after this is going to be 1 1 0 0. Okay, and it will start counting in this manner. So ye is tarike se count karega. Theek hai? So if you know this table, agar aap is table ko properly banayenge, if you try to make this entire table, you will see the counting is from 0. From 0 I am counting 8, from 8 I am counting 12, and from 12 I will be counting this number which is 14, and from 14 I will be counting the next number which is 15. So agli jo number hai aapke paas 15 hogi, and so on. And this entire combination is not matching the first option, it is not matching the second option, it is not matching the third option, it is matching the option number D. So because in a 4 bit Johnson counter you have this count of kind of counting sequence. 4 bit Johnson counter mein aapke paas is tarah ka counting sequence hoga. So basically because of this state, jo aapke Q complement state hai, iski state ki wajah se, first of all I am going to start adding zeros and then I am going to start eliminating zeros. So yahan se aap check karoge, 0 is basically 0, I mean first of all I will start adding ones and then I will start eliminating ones. So here aap ek one add karenge, ab yahan par aap do one add karenge, yahan par aap teen ones add karenge, yahan par aap char ones add karenge. As soon as you got all the ones, now start eliminating the zeros. To yahan par kya hoga, I mean start eliminating the ones. To yahan par kya hoga, this will change to, MSB will change to 0, again this MSB will change to 0. So like this, In this way, you can count here. So this is how it works in Johnson's counter. So the correct answer here is option number D. Very easy and straightforward question. Nothing very difficult in this question. Okay. The next is the minimum number of JK flip-flops required to consider to construct a synchronous counter with a counting sequence which is given here. Now this is very interesting question here because they are giving repeated numbers in the counting sequence. So the counting sequence is like this: 0, 0. I mean, first of all, from 0 you are counting 0, from 0 you are counting going to 1, and from again we are going to 2, and from here I'm going to 3, and then again I'm going to 1. So how many states are there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. But the thing is, if you are going to make a diagram for this, proper diagram, so it is basically from 0, 0, you are counting again 0, 0, and from here you are counting 0, 1, from here you are counting 0, 1, from here you are counting 1, 0, from here you are counting 1, 0, from here you are counting 1, 1, from here you are counting 1, 1, and from here again you are counting 0, 0. But if you look at it here, you cannot make it with two flip-flop. You cannot make it with two flip-flops because the total number of states are 8. Total aapke paas 8 states hain. Plus, you need a method in somehow that you should be able to differentiate between these two zeros. Ab in do zeros ke beech differentiate karne ke liye you need a method somehow so that you can easily differentiate between them. Ab inke beech mein kuch tarike se differentiate kar sake. So what I can do is I can add an extra bit with them. So I can add a bit 0 here, I can add a bit 1 here. I can add a bit 0 here, I can add a bit 1. I can add a bit 0, I can add a bit 1. I can add a bit 0 here and I can add a bit 1. Why? Because without adding this bit, you cannot make 8 states. Aap 8 states nahi bana payenge. Now, this counting changed to 0 and this is basically 4 and this is basically your number which is 1. And from here, this number is basically your 5. From 5, this number is 2. From 2, this number is 6. From 6, this number is 3. And from 3, this number is 7. And from 7, again, we are going to 0. And this is how you can easily count. Okay. Now, what I can do here is, using this counting, I can make a JK flip-flop. So, I can say this is the present state, which is Q0, Q1 and Q2. Right? Q1 and Q2. And then I can find this is the next state, which is Q0 next, Q1 next and Q2 next. Okay. So if the present state is 000, so next state is 100. So present state is, if present state is 001, so the next state is going to be 101. In the same way, you can make this entire table. And for this entire table, you can implement this using JK flip-flops. So you need basically 3 JK flip-flops to implement this. Aapko ise implement karne ke liye 3 JK flip-flops ki requirement hogi. Then how can I get this combination? So you can get this combination only, what you can do is you are using 3 JK flip-flops here and you are connecting these 3 JK flip-flops somehow according to the circuit. Aap in 3 JK flip-flop ko connect karenge. What you can do is instead of taking this output, aap is output ko nahi lenge, you can start taking this output, right? You can only start counting 2 outputs instead of 3 outputs, right? If you start counting 2 outputs, so your combination that you are going to get will be this sequence. Aapko ye sequence milega. What you have to do is karna kya aapko simply you need 3 JK flip-flops to implement this circuit, and out of these three JK flip-flops you need the output of only 2 JK flip-flops. Aapko sirf 2 ka output chahiye, 1 ka output nahi chahiye, because this one is irrelevant here, because if you are going to take this output to aapko sequence nahi milega, you just have to take this output and then you can easily implement it. To yahan par kitne JK flip-flops ke requirement hai? You need a total of 3 JK flip-flops. Very easy problem, it was not difficult. This is a similar question here. So here you have to synchronous counter banana hai. So the counting sequence is like this: 0 to 1, 1 to 0, 0 to 2, 2 to 0 and 0 to 3. Now again the problem here is that in this case you have a total of 6 states. Here you have 6 states hai. So if you have a total of 6 states, to represent these 6 states you need a total of 3 bits, and 3 bits means you need 3 flip-flops. Aapko yahan par 3 flip-flops ki requirement hogi. But how will you differentiate between these states? You have to add an extra bit. Aapko ek extra bit ko add karna padega so that you can differentiate these, right? So here the counting is from 0 to 3, right? So what you can do is, this is representing 0, 0. This is representing 0, 1. This is representing 0, 0. This is representing, here, okay. Let me correct it. So this is representing 10, this is representing 00, and this is representing here 11. But there's a twist here. What is the twist? These number of zeros are basically 3. There are 3 zeros. So if you add one extra bit, then you will not be able to differentiate between these 3 zeros. Aap in 3 zero ke beech mein differentiate nahi kar payenge. So basically, instead of adding 1 bit, you have to add 2 bits of information. Yahan par aapko 2 bit ki information add karni padegi, so that you can differentiate between these 3 zeros. Aapko same states ke beech mein differentiate karna hai. So maybe I can add a 00 here. I can add 01 here. I can add a 10 here. So you can do it this way. Aap is tarike se isko kar sakte hain. Or what you can do here is, you can add a 00 here, you can add a 01 here, you can add a 10 here, you can add a 11, you can add some combination. Maybe you can use a combination 01, and maybe you can use a combination 10 or something. So in this way you can do it. Or second method is, what you can do here is, again add 00 here, add 01 here, add 10 here. Now in other ones you can use in any manner, you can use any combination. You can use 00 here, you can use 00 here, you can use 00 here. So you can see all these states are again unique. Jo sabhi states hain ye sabhi fir se unique ho gayi. All these states are unique. These states are not repeating states. So you got total of 6 states. So for these 6 states you have to make a mod 6 counter, and in that mod 6 counter you need total of 4 bits. Okay, so to implement, to save 4 bit of information, you need 4 JK flip flop. Because aapke paas 4 bit hai, to 4 bit ke liye aapko 4 JK flip flop ki requirement hogi. Because every flip flop is going to store 1 bit of information. So in this case the answer will be 4. Okay, if you feel like that you do not understand how to make it, just let me know in the comment section. I will make a separate video where I can thoroughly solve this question, I can thoroughly make this entire circuit diagram, and you will be able to understand it properly. But again, if you feel like you did not understand, just let me know in the chat window, or just let me know in the comment section of this video. I will make a video, next video on this. Take care, still if you have any kind of doubts. Take care. Next, let us look at this question. It's a very, very easy question. They are saying the next state table of a 2-bit saturating up counter is given below. So we have an up counter here. That means from 00, I'm counting to 01. From 00, I'm counting to 01. From 01, I'm counting to 10. And from 10, I'm counting to 11. So this is your up counter. Counting is like this, which is 0, 1, 2, 3, and again 0. Now they're asking, the counter is built as a synchronous sequential circuit using T flip-flop, the expression for T0 and T1. So what you have to do is, you have to create a T0 here, you have to create a T1 here, and you have to fill this table by using the excitation table of T flip-flop. So what is the excitation table of T flip-flop? This is Q0, this is Q, and this is N, and this is Qn plus 1. So excitation table aap banayenge iski. So this is Qn, and this is Qn plus 1, and this is the value of T. So 00011011. So whenever the output is changing, the value of T is 1, otherwise the value of T is 0, right? So here you have to fill this table. Is puri table ko aap log fill karenge. So for filling this table, you'll get the answer as 0100. I hope मैं आपको काफी अच्छे से बता चुका हूँ how to fill this table. So it is 1100. Now what you have to do is, for T0 you have to create a truth table, and in this truth table again you will get a value for Q0 and Q0 complement and Q. This is Q1 complement and Q1. In the same way you are going to make a K-map for T1 also. So here we have Q0 complement and Q0, and here we have Q1 complement and Q1. So just fill these tables. After filling these tables, you will get in say directly also here also you can also get this value. So this value is basically your Q1 complement Q0, and from here you can see this is representing a NOR gate. ठीक है, तो यहाँ से जो आपकी value आएगी, which is basically only in this case it is 0, otherwise it is 1 for T0. ठीक है, तो so you can fill this value here. Okay, I think I filled it wrong. See, I think I filled these values as wrong. मैं शायद इन values को थोड़ा wrong fill किया हो सकता है. So maybe this is the value of T1. Sorry, this is, I guess this is correct. I'm not sure. This is the value of t1 and this is the value of t0. Okay, so you can get this equation for t0 and you can also get this equation for t1. Ab t0 or t1 ki equation ko find out kar sakte hain. So the equation that you are going to get for t0 is going to be q0 complement, q0 and q1 complement. In the same way for t1 your equation will be as follows. So t1 ki equations kya hogi? It is going to be q0 q1 whole complementation, because this is representing a NAND gate. Ye jo hai, ye ek NAND gate ko represent kar raha hai, correct? So let me write it clearly here. So the output for T0 will be Q1 complement Q0. The output for T1 will be Q0 Q1 whole complementation. And this can also be written as Q0 complement plus Q1 complement. And which is matching which of the options? We have the correct answer is option number B. तो ये जो ऑप्शन आंसर है ये ऑप्शन नंबर बी से मैच हो रहा है. सो ऑप्शन नंबर बी इज द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर दिस गिवन प्रॉब्लम. ठीक है, आई होप दैट यू अंडरस्टूड दिस. अगेन इफ यू फील लाइक यू कैन नॉट अंडरस्टैंड द आउटपुट जस्ट लेट मी नो, आई विल सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन इन द चैट विंडो. ठीक है, आई मीन इन द नेक्स्ट वीडियो. अगर आपको समझ में नहीं आए जस्ट लेट मी नो, एट एनी पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम आई विल मेक अ वीडियो फॉर दिस. ठीक है, नेक्स्ट. अब आपका ये जो क्वेश्चन है दिस इज अ क्रॉस डिसिप्लिनरी क्वेश्चन बिकॉज हियर दे आर आस्किंग अबाउट DFA एंड I've not taught you this ASM as well as अभी मैंने आपको arithmetic state machines and finite state machines आपको नहीं पढ़ाया है. So this DFA we are going to study in theory of computation subject and for the live classes, current live classes हम इसको theory of computation में study करेंगे. That is why you can skip this question as of now and also you can also skip this question because this is a subjective question, it is not objective. ठीक है, so let us take more questions from previous year gate previous year gate digital logic. Okay, so we'll meet in the next video.